You were fried.
Alright, hold on, wait.
It was fucking weak.
The funny thing is, yeah, I thought people would pick up on it, yeah. Hold on, my mic sounds low, man.
Honestly, because
all of you guys fried.
Because number one, yeah, it was the fees from everything. Yeah, this is funny, but you guys be laughing.
We're laughing, yeah. Like, the fees thing was.
That's what gave me. Then I realized, hold on a second, yeah, Gina's actually not here.
I was not.
Wait,
I
was
not.
Everybody fried.
Testing.
Wait, so how come we're not fried?
Because
I don't want to be fried today.
We don't want to. Nah, it's the, we realize that it's not the one. It has to be liquor.
So basically,
now.
Yeah, I thought that people would pick up on it, especially because of the ending of the pod. You heard the ending of the pod?
Where we kept talking about.
And we played South Speed, I get high. But we didn't get no one tweet about it. So I thought, no one. I don't think people clocked. So basically, on last week's episode, guys, we were high the whole time.
Like, all of us.
Oh, man.
Before we recorded,
we were fried.
Wait, Gina, you smoked weed?
Fam, how many times do you want to say it?
I want you to say yes.
Smoking weed.
This is how Gina said the other day, let's go Amsterdam.
Is what you said?
Oh, yeah. I was like, no, go somewhere.
Are we doing it?
I'm on it.
No, I could actually tell. Like, it was literally after the first fees thing, you guys were off for so long. I was like, okay, I know what's going on there. Funny enough, on the weekend, I recorded another pod with my friends, this gaming pod, and I was the only sober one there.
Okay.
Nice.
So I was like, okay, I understand what's going on.
No,
I
was fried. The thing is, and I'm trying my hardest to stay composed.
But he continued. I tapped out.
So who was the supplier of the weed?
Jesse.
Really?
And the funny thing is, Jesse and Gloria. Gina would have been balloons as well.
Hey,
fam.
Gina!
Like, what's mate?
What's wrong with the man?
She was bare giggling, bare happy.
Equia!
What's wrong with the man?
Did you do this in front of Brent?
No, I wasn't here. It was at his house.
Brent wasn't here last week in Croatia.
So this is what happens in your house?
Happens in my house. This is what happened that day because this is what the agenda.
Oh, that sounds fun.
But it didn't, I don't know. I knew what happened to me because when I smoke weed,
How
many times have you smoked weed?
Like twice.
Okay.
I'm not a weed.
In London?
Oh, that was your second time in life?
No, okay, maybe not twice.
I love it. Hold on, were you saying give or pass?
I was like puff give. It's from Friday.
Puff pass.
I know,
but the way you kept saying it,
are you fucking up the rotation?
Oh, mate.
Was she stingy?
No, she was calm. But I'm saying you didn't smoke it like that was your second time. You smoked it a few times.
Like a pro. But I said it's because I do shisha a lot.
Okay.
So I know I'm
used. But it's different though because
she's fucking shisha. You know, it takes shisha.
You don't inhale shisha though.
Yeah, fair enough.
So it's different. But no, I was fried. Yeah, I was fried, and
I was just
the whole time I was thinking. We're just chatting bare shit. This is gonna sound mad.
You know, we're talking about aliens,
like the aliens.
Yeah, the aliens.
Listen, the Area 51 shit. I wanted to laugh, man. I was thinking Yusuff is literally getting the fact that he might be.
Oh, and Gloria of racism, isn't it?
Oh yeah. Gloria was a bit mad.
Like, you're not gonna chat me here. I don't care if the orange show.
It's true,
because
then, yeah.
Because I was high, man. This is basketball, man. You know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, no.
I'm done.
Now I know where it's from here. It just makes it so much more funny. Woo!
Oh, my God. And then,
did you guys see?
She was bare, Gina was bare quiet, and she kept getting aggy about the whole beating.
Yeah.
Her beating her.
I'm looking him out.
No, not beating her. Beating her. If her partner. Her partner beat her.
Yeah.
I was like, we're swinging.
I thought you were moving a bit. I was going to message you and be like, Gina, you're moving.
You know what killed me? Someone tweeted.
Because she was high, man.
Someone tweeted and I was like, oh shit. And they were like, oh, there's a common correlation between people that get beat up of when I saw the tweet here, I said, shit, then. There's a common correlation between people that get beat as children and domestic violence.
Yeah.
And I was like, shit, then.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because it did sound a bit like you were condoning a bit of.
I didn't know. I wasn't.
A bit of give and take, no?
No, you were basically saying that if he hits you, you'll hit them back, and that's it.
That's it. No, I asked you,
are you leaving? You're like, no, I'm staying.
No, yeah, you said, yeah.
You said, and you, you're going to love me
and beat me.
All right.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, next time we may have to have a sip because.
No, we're going to sip next
time. The weed ain't the one still.
Invite me next time.
No, it was too low. But when you're sipping, it's like you get.
Lively.
Yeah, you get real lively.
Invite me next time.
Yeah, don't worry.
No, we'll do.
Shout out Patron.
Patron, you know. But yeah, how are we doing though? We good?
We're good.
It's fucking hot, man.
Honestly, man.
Well, not in here. Here's nice and cool, but fam. What, 35?
Yeah. Yesterday, I
didn't sleep, you know.
Yeah. I took my nephew swimming, yeah. And I didn't bring my shorts with me, but I was so tempted just to brave and just jump it.
Honestly,
it was horrible.
In your bite?
In my pants, yeah.
You're going to swim in your pants?
In my boxer briefs, man.
Right, bro.
No, just make sure it ain't the one with the little buttons, boy. Before you get slipped. You get a little slip. The ones that have all the, with the, yeah, with the little slip.
Yeah, the little, ooh.
Yeah, that is long.
Now I wear pants, man.
Your what? Pants?
Tight pants.
I'm joking.
Do you really?
Like boy pants.
At your age.
Sit, no, but a little Calvin Klein
pants. Pant, no?
What, pants? No, I wear
pants. Like the tight boxer thing.
Oh, trunks.
Is that
I don't like trunks. Trunks ride up my legs. I don't like
them. Nah, I don't want
to
see that.
Depends on what size you get, to be fair.
I get extra large.
But that's the cottony ones, right?
Yeah.
That's like this material, but...
Yeah, yeah.
Just boxers, isn't it?
Yeah,
no,
like...
I need a man in that so I can see the print.
No. Trunks are good if you're going for a link.
Yes.
Yes!
The ones.
Or like a little... He's right. Face tag.
Yeah. You got a link... on the trunks because obviously it hugs
the
bum
and then the grey pants
it hugs the package
it hugs the meat
gray,
man.
And on a normal day
you know I'm clocking my face I'm just looking at all of you thinking you're nasty.
Well, that's true though, you got a link young designer trunk
but then you need a nice Nike tracksuit in grey.
Why?
So that I can also see the print.
You're a sexual deviant, bro.
I swear.
Literally.
And not all of us are like, I'm sure some of us are growers. So.
I hate that. Own your speak your truth. Speak your no. Speak your truth, we will. Speak your truth. Yeah. We will not be condoning.
Will come cuss you and say, don't say anything if your dick ain't longer than your balls.
What?
No, but I saw someone.
That's impossible.
That.
You're gonna say your dick ain't longer than your balls.
How?
What? So your dick's sitting
like
on your balls?
Yeah.
It's like a nest. Your balls is nesting your dick. Fam. That's non-existent. I don't think that even, I think that's like, no offense, but no, let me say it.
Yeah.
Because it's a certain region.
Can we not talk about the meats?
Country or continent where those things are, I think, are common.
What's his
phone's at?
No, I know what you're talking about.
I mean, like.
You said it, but I'm not saying it.
Mulan and the man.
Dim sum and the man.
No, I said Mulan.
No, how can you say dim sum?
No, you know what?
I said Mulan.
And name.
Yours was worse.
What's bread?
Where's bread?
What do you mean? You said Mulan.
Yeah, but that's not as bad as what you said.
No. To be fair, once it wasn't bad because that can describe the actual piece itself. Like it looks like dim sum, so that's not even bad. But you,
I don't even know what dim sum
are generalizing.
Dim sum's a dumpling.
A nation by talking about Mulan.
A dim sum is a dumpling. Why does it look like a dumpling?
No, but there's different types of dim sum. There's one that looks like a little shell thing.
Okay.
So someone's penis looks like it.
Big man, you tell me because I ain't seen none.
I don't know. I haven't dated an Asian person.
Mine. Who said that about you?
You've never seen any of your friends' pieces?
No. When
really?
Would that? When would that have occurred?
Like when you guys are like changing and shit.
No. Listen,
I guess it's just girls that do that.
Yeah, I think it is.
I think you're speaking.
That what? See each other's.
Like when you're getting changed.
I mean, white man in the gym, they love getting naked around.
Yeah, when you're getting changed.
Oh, yeah, the funny thing, I've seen strangers' penises because some guys in the gyms are just flirting.
They don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
No, I've seen you.
They'll come to you. Oh, good workout, mate.
No.
Wait.
Now you didn't see me naked.
We're missing some good conversation over here. So you're saying that you've seen Gina naked?
Not shit. Do you know
what? Gina's definitely seen me naked.
Where did I see you naked? You FaceTimed me and you're naked.
I've seen it from the back.
We're getting ready to go out. This girl, yeah. Guy.
Just so you know, there is such thing as group FaceTime now, by the way, guys. Just
them ones. Yeah. Hear that.
Fair enough.
But, yeah, no, she definitely hasn't seen me naked. I know that for a fact.
Oh, maybe it's a bum.
Because I don't... Yeah. No, you know what it is? You can see my bum. I don't care, but everything else, I'm a bit timid, but... I'm just,
I like it.
No,
the thing is, I can't imagine.
I don't mind.
I can imagine you being free, like you just free up when you're around the girl. I don't imagine you being free up.
Never. Ask Doreen. I remember one time Doreen came to my house after uni. She was like, "You still do that?" I was like, "Doreen,
do what?
Me, man. Like when I get changed,
I cover up
and go in the corner, turn around." But Doreen's been, listen,
pussy fresh.
From uni, Doreen has been.
You have to, man.
What? I've seen everything.
Well, then the people are creaming and they're creaming like one arm because and then the towel drops and then they're like, oh. And they're trying to catch the towel.
I'm like,
oh, come on, man. Don't be frigid like that, man.
You know what?
So you put your sports bra on top.
And then you drop it down.
What about you in the gym? Are you like a...
No way. Listen,
I don't ever get changed in the gym, though. Listen, I don't ever shower there.
I don't shower.
Oh, before work in the mornings, definitely I'd have to shower before work. But... I'd normally like bring my fresh boxes into the shower with me. Like, there's no way I'm walking.
Oh, so you do it?
Yeah,
oh,
I'll do it. Okay. There's no way. Like, I've
what if they drop?
But you can walk out the shower in your towel.
I got to firm it. Yeah, I walk in the shower with my towel and that.
Yeah.
Not in fact, okay, after my workout, I'll walk into the actual shower with my towel and obviously wearing my old boxers.
Yeah.
And then when I come out, I'm wearing my new boxers I've taken with me.
But you ain't creamed yet though, big man. You ain't creamed yet though.
Yeah, I'll cream when I get out.
No, but let me ask
you. But you already put the boxes on. Doesn't matter. So you ain't gonna cream the cooch.
Yeah, of course I will. But I'll feel comfortable.
Let me ask you a question, yeah? But you got a towel, innit?
Yeah.
And your towel's around your waist. So why can't you just walk free and then when you get there, put your boxes on underneath?
I don't think about it.
That's extra for the reason. Why am I going to walk free? Might as well just cover up.
No, it's not free.
Oh, just a towel.
That's what I mean.
I'm not even going to change, like, actually get naked in the actual, like, changing room. I don't feel comfortable doing that.
Yeah, I know, but I don't do that either.
I just don't.
Yeah, but you know what? Your body's like a Greek god, isn't it? Do you know what I mean?
Listen, sometimes hard work pays off, isn't it?
But your body is amazing.
Nah, bruv. When I'm in them gym settings, I just look at, I'm just like,
a couple of times, a guy's literally tapping my shoulder. Like while he's naked and trying to start talking to me, I'm like,
yes, Brent.
Entree. God will bless you, man.
Oh, it's ice lollies.
Yeah, we. Dami. Requested.
Yeah. Well, I was gonna go buy some for everyone. So.
God bless you.
Rocket isn't that.
Yeah, I don't eat bananas, so can I? Hello, why is this Rocket for me?
Mom's supposed to choose from the selection, guys.
But how are we gonna talk and lick ice lollies? And can I have a mango?
I'll definitely manage still.
I think the banana ones.
Which one is the mango? What, this mango lolly?
No, banana lolly.
God bless you, Brent, man.
A bit of me still.
Yeah, thank you.
No, it's definitely the weather for this still.
Honestly.
Eating this in peace is going to be a problem, man.
It's true, actually. But this is not even my idea. This is Yudo's idea. You don't want to do play school.
Play school.
Just eat our ass lollies, but make sure we don't, you know, lick on the mic and slurp on the mic and all that. on the mic.
Do some ASMR.
Take a lick and come back. Right, this is kind of nice still.
Mm-hmm.
Like a little milky thing, banana thing. Gina's got her... Cauliflower and whatever that is.
What's the meat?
She got a green tea, man.
Oh, cheeky bit of lamb.
All right, so what's it called? Do you cream your balls? Do you put your towel on?
You cream your balls
and your boxes, and then you take your boxes off, and then you put your hands into your towel to cream your balls and stuff.
No. I'll literally cream. Reach down and cream.
Oh, you reach. So you put your hand into your boxes.
Yeah.
But then you're going to get you're going to get cream on the boxes.
That just sounds like stress.
Be honest, do you cream your ass? Because I don't.
Yeah. Wait, stop. You don't cream your ass.
Wait, your ass cracked.
You got a dry black ass. Because we all know your ass is hella black. You got a dry black ass.
I cream my ass on special occasions.
Wait, as if your ass.
Wait, I don't understand this. Why don't you cream your ass?
I don't know.
No, I cream my ass, man.
You're lazy, bro.
Yeah.
No, I'm not.
I only really cream like
sometimes.
Let me give you an example. Yeah. So today,
people see.
Yeah, like no, but let me tell you something. Today,
I
didn't even cream.
Don't cream your ass.
Let me tell you after today. Yeah,
you still look. You don't cream your ass.
But why? It's there to be touched.
You know. Let me listen.
No, what I'm saying is, it's not like it's hard to get at the back.
I had a shower. I bathed twice in it. Second time was after gym, and then I was like, it's too hot, I'm not creaming. No, so I didn't cream.
Come in here, I didn't cream.
I didn't cream. Which is why my ankle
Brent didn't cream. Yeah, but Brent that's gave fine. Me some. Brent gave that's me fine. Some you're not creaming on a particular occasion, but you say you don't cream your ass.
Yeah.
Like, it's a special thing. Like,
but then, but
okay,
why?
Let me explain
something. And what's special to you? Getting hit from the back?
It doesn't get, it doesn't get itchy.
I said, that don't happen. So what's the special occasion?
It doesn't get itchy, but you know what it is? I'm going to be honest. I'm always rushing in it. I realize I only really cream like my whole body. Yeah. When I have time and I'm like, I'm not in a rush to go anywhere and I'm like, I'm just chilling.
Yeah.
Ooh, generally speaking, I'm always in a rush. So I'm just like, I don't even cream myself properly. Like I come out of the shower, it's like quick face, like.
Bruv, you've got Andrex in your bumhole, bruv. Because.
Andrex in my bumhole?
Yeah, you got that tissue residue.
Why did you get that?
Because you don't cream it though. So you don't even know what's back, what the back there.
No, I washed my ass, you prick.
When you wash, you put your hand in.
I washed my ass.
I don't think you
did the washes. I washed my ass thoroughly.
You have to pull out your whole like sleeve.
Yo, you got like bits of Kleenex up in there still.
Nah, do you know what? These days I've been having that
because
issue.
Because that doesn't make any sense. If I didn't wash my ass, then fair enough.
Yeah.
I wash my ass thoroughly and I shower twice a day.
I don't believe you.
But these days I have had that issue.
What so
sometimes
issue?
Like with
tissue being stuck in your ass.
So then I have to jump into the shower to get out.
Yeah. To be fair, a lot of times man uses the manual bidet.
Yeah.
As no, in, it's not really the bidet. I've made it the bidet. Yeah.
So, do you know what, yeah?
Obviously, man gets the...
How did you make a bidet? You know what,
yeah, because I've got a shower and I've got a bath. And in the bath, I've got the actual shower head, the loose thing, the elephant trunk thing.
Yeah.
So I sit on the bath, turn the water on, and I put the shower thing underneath my ass and I clean it thoroughly.
Why don't you just get into the shower?
Every time I go to the toilet?
Yeah.
And I've got to re-cream in that. That's long. And I've got to do the beard oil again. That's long.
Why do you do the beard oil if you're washing your ass?
So why don't you
If I get in the shower, then it's going to be a full body wash.
Use wipes. Get baby wipes. Yeah.
It's true. Well, to be fair,
do you
know what, yeah? Fatima did a bathroom recently and she's actually got a, what do you call it? She's got
a bidet.
Not a bidet, what's it called? It's the other thing that with the pipe. You know, Thingy's got it as well. Alim's got it in her yard as well. What's it called, man?
What is it?
The pipe. I forgot what it's called, man. That you get it, it's in all the mosque you'll go to in the toilet. The Thingy, the pipe with the sprayer.
So the one that comes out of the bidet.
Yeah.
So you know that when you see
yeah.
The thing at the back.
Oh.
Yeah.
And you can bring it up and go
Yeah.
I won't lie to you, yeah. Like I've overused it still.
Yeah. No way, I don't feel nice. I don't just tissue doesn't really feel, you know what I mean? It's dry.
Yeah, especially when you've done the shit.
It needs some moisture first.
Isn't that the only time you're really cleaning your ass?
No, I clean my ass sometimes when I pee. Because sometimes it's hard to like wipe.
Huh? You clean your ass when you pee, why?
Because sometimes it's hard to wipe. And sometimes that like, drip down
Drip.
So I have to wash.
Oh shit. All right.
Wait, hold on, but then doesn't that mean, like, because some days if I've like missed creaming, sometimes my crack gets really dry and like you don't have that
either. This is TMI still.
I feel like I'm good.
What was I going to say?
No, because dry particles.
Yeah, you don't like here.
How's your back though?
No.
How's your back creaming game though? Because mine's swag.
Yeah, honestly,
mine's
good. I got arms like a T-Rex. I got arms like a T-Rex. No way I'm ever able to reach that.
My back must be the driest thing on earth because I can't hit.
So, can you not do this?
All I can hit is my lower back.
You do this.
And I can hit the top bit and I can hit the top bit. The middle of my back is probably like the Sahara Desert, bro.
Because of your muscles.
Listen,
if you're not double jointed, it's going to be impossible.
I'm not double jointed. I can cream my back.
No, you must be double jointed.
Look.
All right, go on, touch the whole thing.
You do this.
Bruv, yeah, I can't do that.
Bruh.
I cannot do that.
Yeah, I can't do that.
Bruh, I thought everyone could do
my
that.
Lower back and then there and there.
That's it.
That's it. I can't reach any more other places.
This is why you need a girlfriend.
Listen, when I had a girlfriend, it was, yeah, babe, can you come back for me? She's like, yes.
Oh, honestly.
Oh, but then you're happy when it turns into sex.
It doesn't really turn into sex, to be fair, because when I do it, I actually want my back creams. Because I just got the shower.
It's just me, sorry.
You're a freak nasty.
Not anymore, but yeah.
Yeah, no, those are definitely one of the perks of having a girlfriend or having a girl over. I don't know 100%. About them things there, but having your back creamed in the morning as a guy who can't cream his back is brilliant.
That sounds kind of disgusting.
What do you mean?
Having your back creamed in the morning.
Yeah, because you're dirty and you're thinking about other things.
Oh, Lord.
This episode started off so left of field. I said it's good.
With your nasty ass, your breast out now.
It's not out.
Well,
I'm not saying it at all.
Kind of.
Covered.
No?
No, they're covered.
Alright.
Everything covered. Everything blessed.
Have you seen the Alex Mann from Glastonbury?
Yeah, that's a joke thing, man. I just ignored it.
What did he do?
He's got a video on Graham Daly.
He has a tune up.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Swear.
Music industry in this country is fucked, you know.
It's a joke. It's an absolute joke.
It's tapped.
No, but who signed him? It might just be Graham Daly.
It's your label still.
No, it wasn't.
It was Sony.
Play, please.
It was Sony.
Can we not? I don't even why are we giving him spins?
What's it called? Let me check it out.
It's called, here it is.
No, I play it, I wanna hear it.
I do.
It's Alex from Glastow.
What's his name? Alex Glastow.
Alex, man. What's going on there?
We on stage with my hat low. Good energy with my cash flow. What do you know about that, bro? It's Alex from Glastow. See me on stage with my hat low. Good energy with my cash flow. What do you know about that, bro? 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 That's Alex from Glastow. See me on stage with my hat low. Good energy.
By the way, this is just the promo video. It's not the actual song.
Doesn't matter.
I hope it's shit, and then it gets dropped.
Is it out already?
Yeah. Yo.
I'm gonna hit bars.
Alex from Glastow. I'm back though. Shout out Santan Dave. Put me on his back though. Put me on stage though. That one got enough. Signed though.
Stop.
To Sony.
He didn't Chris get was my A&R, though. Shut Yusuff. Up. I don't know. I think it's a Graham Daly thing. I don't think a label signed him because it's not on Spotify.
Okay. No, I heard he got signed, actually.
I heard that.
That's people such a joke to him. Thing,
I don't
though,
think
man.
He got signed.
Are you surprised with what's her face got signed? Loz girl.
Oh yeah.
I don't. She didn't get signed.
Did you get signed though?
No.
Osh got signed though.
No. Yeah, Osh got signed.
Yeah, but he's significantly more talented than her.
No, he's talented. But where is he now though?
Fuck. Making music. He dropped music.
When?
Like a month ago.
Oh okay, I hear it. I'm not even trying to share. I'm saying.
Yeah, he dropped music. Dropped two tracks actually.
But the thing is, this we live in an era where if something goes viral, something gets numbers and clicks. That's when the labels and the businesses gravitate towards it.
Well, yeah, because it's business, isn't it? We've got to make money.
But imagine if you're an artist. I say this all the time, but people say all the time, you're an artist who've been in the game for years.
And I do.
This must piss you off.
I do feel for those people because it's like I've got talent. I've been working. And if you just believed in me.
I've been working since Sidewinder.
I'm dead.
Am I lying? I've been on this thing since Pirate Radio.
And this DVD, Risky
Rose. I lie. Risky Rose. Risky Rose, volume one.
It ain't even volume three.
Fucking
one.
Fuck radio. You know what I mean? Lord of the Mics one.
He's clashed with all of them.
Yeah. You know I mean? I clashed Devil Man, big man. And you're telling me that this brother who just got brought on stage by Santan David now got a track and he's signed.
Yeah, it's for sure.
And he's on Piers Morgan. I mean, he ain't even got F64, big man. Or Daily Duppy.
Bruv, not even a
behind bars. Huh?
Not even a fire in the booth, bro.
Not even a fire in the booth. Imagine, so the funny thing is, in this day and age, you probably have a fire in the booth.
No, because he can't rap.
He goes right.
You're saying, wait, no, because you still need to be able to deliver.
Hold on. I'm sure someone wrote this song. I haven't heard the whole song, but I'm sure
it's 100%. And even from that, what do you know about glass door? That doesn't sound great. That's not great delivery.
Yeah, of course not. Yeah, because he's not
if
a rapper.
Someone said that to me, I would never sign that.
Yeah, but I wouldn't sign that even if it sounded good. Because
even if he says free as that now, brother, I'm not even trying to waste my resources.
I know
on
where
that.
He came from. I know what his fame is based off of. And that's not going to last long. You know what I mean? Like, this is going to be a flash in the pan.
And that's it.
The thing is, if he blows, he blows. I'm not hating on him. I'm just saying.
No, I'm definitely hating still.
Yeah, I'm hating. I want to be a drop.
I'm definitely hating.
You want to get dropped?
And he's not even signed yet.
So you want him to get dropped? Let him live. This is God's plan for him, isn't it? So it's all good.
Yeah.
It's just that I'm not an artist, I don't give a shit. Too tough. But if you're an artist and you see this, you're thinking, what more do you want from me? Am I lying?
No, it's true.
Fuck.
It's true. I feel their pain.
Man said glass though.
When I'm in meetings and I'm just like, what is this,
bro? So, hold on. Give me a little insight to some of the past that happened in terms of like.
What do you mean?
Like, if someone suggests an artist is shit.
No, I guess, do you know, it's not even an artist is shit. It's just when you're in like A&R meetings, everyone has different tastes in it.
Yeah.
Like, my kind of nickname is Queen of Afrobeats. So people come to me about Afrobeats and if they want someone to collab. But, you know, I'm in a room sometimes and people are doing like indie music or pop or whatever, you know, people that do like Rag and Bone Man. So that's a different type of taste. And then you got people that A&I notes at the same time. So it's all, you've all got different tastes in the room, but you're just trying to find, sometimes it's not even about what song is shit. Sometimes just where can we position this in the market? Right? So it might be a song that I don't particularly like, but I'm like, oh, I can see like white teenage girls liking this. So it can be positioned that way. So even if it's not my taste, I can be like, it's a cool song. So, because you know, I tend to do more urban and Afro beats rather than the indies and the whatever. But there's certain songs that I'm now in the label and I'm like, oh, yeah, actually like this and like this artist. Like,
sorry, I make sure I'm in the shot though, because YouTube things.
It's all taste. And the same time as well, with certain people, it's like, my boss has been in the game for like 25 years, right? So you kind of defer to him to know, to kind of understand that he knows what makes a hit. And so even if it's urban or if it's pop or it's indie, he can be like, I don't think that's going to, it's a good song, but I don't think that's going to be a hit. Or actually, it's not that great of a song, but I can see how this could pop off in the market. So it's just kind of trusting the A&R instinct, I guess. And I don't have that yet.
I hear that. What was I going to say? It slipped my mind. Yes. Have you seen the Miss Banks's ex, Lawrence?
Yeah,
it's in the video. So we had a big debate in the group earlier. Yeah. Shout out to Jesse and Gloria. So hold on.
Can I be added to this group, please?
Yeah.
Because like this group sounds lit.
I'm not gonna lie, it is. But you lot are too active for me. Right?
No, Jesse and Gloria are very active.
They're too active. You know listen, what? I can wake up here to about 200. I'm thinking, fam.
Reason being, they have desk jobs.
It's true. That's,
that's
it
why.
Because and that's the thing, yeah. And I realize that because it's like it's too consistent. I will scroll up, yeah, and you know when I can't even be bothered to, like, so today, sorry, I didn't even catch up. I thought, nah, I just sent that guy's video in.
So can you guys add me or not?
Because I was like,
Or do you have to, like, is it a vote?
I think we have to vote.
We have to vote.
Yeah, we have to vote.
Yeah, can you guys
committee.
Vote by committee, please?
Yeah, and then
I'll go talk to the other board members.
Yeah, speak to the other board members, because it's not going to lie, the group's lit.
Bro, it sounds hella every week.
No, it is.
In the group chat. Because on a daily basis, we discussed it in the group chat.
On a daily basis.
Listen, Gloria is the one. She's throwing in things.
Even Gloria throws things to me sometimes.
It's Gloria
and Jessie. Always throws stuff when about men. You know, like when Twitter, when people talk about, like, dating preferences. Gloria chucks that, and I'm like, Gloria, I saw it too.
All right, so here's the video, but it's nothing to hear. It's just a visual, isn't it, so. So basically, that's you know Lawrence TK.
Yeah,
that's him on holiday.
Jacuzzi,
you know, showing what he's doing. He's with two girls.
Oh no,
we think he's heartbroken.
They got fat asses. He's zooming into the asses, showing his face, showing the pool, the hotel, and just basically showing what he's doing.
Yeah,
we still think he's heartbroken.
So the argument was: is he doing it because he's heartbroken and he's showing out because he wants Miss Banks to see it, or is he just doing him?
You know what it is?
This is a bit much though. Especially the girl in the green.
Let me tell you what it is. The reason why I agree with Gloria is because I've been following Lawrence for time, innit?
Yeah.
So fair enough, when I started following him before them two were even like a public couple.
Yeah.
He went on that vibe.
Yeah.
So it's
he's hurt, man.
No, so that's what I'm saying. So
cheers, Lawrence.
It comes across as like, yeah, I'm licking my wounds, but I'm trying to show everyone that I'm out here living my best life.
It's a bit much. It's
yeah,
OT.
Because
it's
thing is, my thing is, you don't even have to snap that shit. He can just do it.
Yeah, and we know that he's there with.
You know what I mean, but he wants everyone to see. He wants her to see it. But
precisely.
But why would you? Thing is, as a man, maybe you can answer this question, or maybe you can chime in. Why would you want your ex to see that anyway?
Because I wouldn't care.
No, but you wouldn't do it. But I'm saying.
But yes, remember the reason why they broke up is because she broke up with him.
Shout
right?
out to Banksy.
So, because she broke up with him, he didn't want to, you know what I mean? It's not like he wanted the breakup. Yeah. So it's like, you're the one left lagging behind. Like, you're the one who's licking your wounds because it's not a decision that you
and
really
she's
paying, wanted.
So other men are still moving.
Yeah, but is he doing this because he wants her to be like, rah, look at him with these two girls. You know, I want him back. Like, what is his intention?
No, I'm moving on, innit? Like, I'm good. I'm like, good. You know when it's like, I'm good over here.
I'm sure she knows that already, though.
Yeah, but it's different to like, she knows. Like, I need her to see it and feel it.
Yeah, but is this, and is this really it though?
But regardless, as a female, if I saw that, I'd still feel some type of way naturally.
Yeah.
Just naturally, not because I'm...
Would you?
Yeah, like
even though you know that you are secure in...
No.
You broke up with him.
In the sense of, I'd feel some type of way and I'd be like, are you five?
Yeah.
Like,
that's what I'm saying. To me, it's a bit immature.
I wouldn't find
because
that.
You can go on holiday and chop bare things. You don't have to film it.
I would never
show it,
see that and want you back.
Yeah, I wouldn't bring you back.
I would literally
that's
be
what
like,
I'm saying. This,
I would literally be like, rah.
Won't this make it worse?
Are you like, cool story, bro.
It'll make it worse, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well done.
Yeah.
Because the worst thing is, she's not out here with bare other man them. Like, she generally just focused on her career.
Yeah, doing her. Mm.
Doing her.
Just being her. And that's, man, and they moved to
it. It is what it is. Do you know what I mean? So I think it just, he's bitter and he's pressed.
Because that is flagrant. That's what you guys that is literally.
He had two, not had one girl, he had two girls.
Two, and hug me. They go like, hug me.
And you know what? Let me tell you which one. She came over and it was like, come.
With the green.
The green.
And she's like, hug
me.
Yeah, hug me.
It's hella cringe.
Yeah, it's
cringy, man. You know what it actually reminds me of? Remember that Meek Mill video where he's like, I need love. And he's drinking.
No.
You have seen it. Where's my phone?
But to me, it seems like he's, as I like to say, fucking through the pain.
Yeah.
Fucking through the pain, man. It's basketball, man. But no, I think just his argument was, that's just him living life. And then Gloria was like, no, he's putting on the pantomime. Like,
no, it's Panto. Show.
It's Panto, isn't it? Why is everyone on their phone? What's going on here, bro?
Where is Panto?
Sorry. Jobs are calling. Sorry.
Bro, what's this? Akato?
Are you mad?
No, the back looks like a... What's the phone with the H? Huawei.
No, it's like a thing.
Okay. This is
Otterbox.
Oh, those ones.
Yes,
yeah, so Otterbox. So that's for the. Are you just holding it like that, isn't it?
Yeah, sometimes I just put it on the desk so that I can see it.
Patch. Okay. So in them situations, girls, if you see your ex moving like that online, is that
this video?
That's not something you want. Oh, this one.
No, because at the same time, you're moving a bit mad. Because when you're my boyfriend, you're supposed to have like this boyfriendly, wholesome image. And I just moving mad with these two girls.
I just think for me, it will just reiterate and confirm
why I don't want,
why
you,
I don't want you. Yeah, for me, it's like...
But based on your inside knowledge, is this does this correlate with her reason to break up with him or the reason why she broke up with him? Gina.
No comment.
When, I was about to say, I cannot
discuss. No, you were about
client,
to say
something. My client.
No, I was about to come and say, I was literally about to come and say, I'm not at liberty to disclose such information.
Okay, have you spoken to Miss Banks? Have you got any news for us? Have you spoken to her?
I don't have any news since
the video surfaced.
No, I have not.
We're going to our correspondent, Gina Obey.
We're going to our gossip correspondent, Gina.
The weather is currently 31
degrees. A scene by just Gina.
Will Miss Banks be releasing a diss track?
Will she be releasing her own video?
Right. I'm done.
Will she ever text me back? No, I'm joking. I'm joking.
Find out in the next episode.
He's not.
I
see. No, she texted me back, but it wasn't like a, it was a friendly text. It wasn't that flagrant. Okay. Yeah, hold on. You haven't done my plan yet.
I know. Right?
What's going on?
To be fair, things have been a bit. You know what I mean?
Well, you haven't seen her.
No.
Oh, I gave Gina a foolproof speech.
Yeah, I'm still gonna do it. When I the worst thing is
no, it's foolproof. But now, no, it is that speech is kind of.
No, I'm still gonna do it.
No, you can do it, but it's based on time. Now, so much time has lapsed. Is like, is that speech still relevant now?
I'm still gonna ask.
All right, cool.
I mean, what have I got to lose?
You think it's lost its potency, you know?
Exactly, because so much time has gone. And it was a very time-specific speech.
Write some new bars then.
All right, cool.
Get your bars up, nigga.
Yusuff looking like a snack. Miss Banks ready to attack. I want to talk about NBA free agency, but I don't know if Gina can partake.
It's basketball, man.
Wait, before we get into that, you guys are talking about unknown team actually being convicted.
Yeah, I need to clear that up.
So
he's not convicted. Though.
Not convicted.
He got charged.
That's the word.
Who you spoke about?
Yeah,
last week.
You don't remember?
Yeah, you spoke last week.
Because I was high, man.
Because it was actually joint enterprise.
Yeah.
No, but I was saying how everyone's so quick to like to kind of throw him away.
Yeah.
And I was like, these times he hasn't been convicted, he's been charged.
Well, the point I was going to make is that, funny enough, this last week, there's this other guy that's probably came out around the same time as Unknown T, but he's American.
Oh, yeah. He's take been it. Gone for 55 years.
55 years, take it. Yeah, basically. Yeah, 55. He's like, he done these crimes when he was 16, 17, right?
55?
55 years. If I tell you what the guy did,
life stretch.
Okay, so basically, it's a double murder.
Yeah.
Robbery. Yeah. And I think he assaulted a 65. He pistol whipped a 65-year-old. But basically, the way it happened was, the first charge, basically, there was a warrant out for him. And he basically went on the run. He went on the run, and while he was on the run,
he made a track of it.
He made a music video of him being on the run, an actual full music video. And then in the music video, he's posing next to him, he's wanting the poster. Because it was in, I think it was in East Texas, obviously in East Texas, like that's how they move in it kind of thing. So there's actually a wanted poster for him out there as well. So he did all of that, and then, funny enough, that tracking video was used as evidence against him. Cool, but free take it anyway, man. He didn't do shit.
Okay, this guy.
I said, I said it was joint enterprise, okay. Right?
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
So the other guy wasn't apparently not a rapper,
the guy that actually did it already got killed in a revenge attack like a month after.
Okay.
So now they're just charging everyone else on joint enterprise.
Okay. Oh, fair enough. Which is very unfortunate, but wait, it's all part of the game, isn't it? The game's all part of the game.
Listen,
like when
the you do the crime, you do the time.
This is it. Even if you didn't do the crime yet,
but like, you rode out with your boy.
Apart from stealing from Tesco, that's perfect.
Yeah, but I mean, joint enterprise.
A good law, to be frank, because if you're all riding out with your boy and you're all in a fight, and one of you guys are the ones that actually had the knife and killed your friend, but you're all stamping out this guy.
Yeah.
You all had the intention to either kill him or cause him. No, you had the intention.
Yeah, so charge me for the kicks I gave.
Brother,
I lie.
No, because you guys GBH. Were all riding out
No,
together.
GBH for me.
No, because you guys are all riding out
No,
together.
GBH for me.
No.
No, GBH for me. All right, so if us four...
Get that in
if us, if us four, if us four were beat up Brett, and you killed Brett with a knife, but what I did was give Brett a slap on the back of the head.
Do you know what it is? They were still charging for
GBH.
Because you all had the intention.
Would you give a slap on the head?
No, your intention was to kill him because you killed him. My intention was to give him a slap on the head.
But you know the definition for murder?
He's
the intention to kill or to cause grievous... Yeah.
No,
Cause okay, cool.
All right, forget GBH then.
No, no, but I'm saying
minor assault.
You did. No. You wanted to cause GBH.
Yeah, you slapped him in the head.
Is on the same par as murder, basically. Yeah.
Okay,
so...
cool. Then let's take it down, Notch. Let's take it down to what? Assault.
How?
No, self defense, because he hit me first. Anyway.
But you know, no, but because assault, do you know, and this is strange. Assault is not actually the physical action.
Okay,
you can spit on someone.
Yeah.
All right, self defense then.
No, self defense.
No, what you actually saying?
If he hits me first.
No, what you actually saying is assault and battery. Yeah. Assault is just you can assault someone without touching them because assault is just the other person having an apprehension of immediate force.
All right, cool.
So you can just say. You can just always harass me at a bus stop.
You're a lawyer, lawyer. All
right, yeah, all right, hold on.
You can harass me at a bus stop every day and I'm scared and that's assault. All
right, if the footage, the CCTV footage shows me giving Brent one lick and then dusting off, if he carry on and you stab him up, I might still get charged for
it. Yeah, you
probably, yeah.
But I gave him one bag of the dust.
We all did it together.
No, you three stayed and then shoot him up, bang,
you
bang.
Know what it is?
I left.
it's down to your lawyer, isn't it?
Yeah, I left.
If your barrister is on... Is on job.
The footage shows Yusuff left then, 10 minutes before the murder occurred.
Yeah, but that's fine.
Because the only thing that your lawyer would have to do is sever our cases.
Yeah.
So we get tried together and you get tried by yourself.
If you get trialed separately,
I'm a free man.
You're in a better position.
Yeah, actually, I'll be free.
Not really, because then we can snitch on him.
It's true.
And say it was his plan.
Snitch what? The camera saw me bang him and leave.
But we can say that before we came in, you said, so what I'm going to do,
I'm going to bang him.
And you suckers would do that to me, right? Yeah, you do that to me.
You severed your case, man. Fuck you.
I didn't sever my case.
No, but
I'm just saying, you know what if
the moment you decide to get trial separately, everyone's gonna start thinking he's gonna turn on us.
Yeah.
How? When the footage is there,
that's what's gonna happen.
But
it's like,
you think that that's what they did for when they see
when
us.
When they see us.
No, because you guys don't trust me. That's what it's down to.
No, yeah. Why'd you trust though, bro? No,
because
I'm not here for this. Let me
explain
something to you, yeah. This is the thing. From what I understand, yeah, when you're on the roads,
yeah.
It's all part of the game. Is the game?
No one's talking about the roads. I'm talking about us four.
The game is the game. So if I'm riding out with you because we're gonna do a move, yeah, and I know that potentially this could go left,
yeah,
I know what I'm doing. If that's the case, get out of the car and don't go. I lie.
True.
No, but this is a whole. Okay, cool. Now you're painting a whole new scenario. Okay, cool.
No, but that is how all right, cool. Roads
so
is, isn't it?
But that's how they will see it though. If, for example, you all were going to deal with someone, and you knew you were going to deal with someone, and you knew that there is always going
to
be a possibility for it to go left,
yeah.
You stayed, you took part.
No, I left.
Fam,
you had the mens rea.
Yeah,
I told you, I left. I gave one bang. I got my bang in. Boom, I was gone, bro.
So that's the mens rea. The bang.
The intention.
To what?
To either kill or cause
bodily harm. To kill you now.
Or cause bodily harm. Remember the definition for murder.
Listen, you're going down for life anyway because you killed him. You're the one who put a knife in him.
Yeah, for real.
You're going.
She did.
I don't know why we're bare laughing.
Don't try to rope me in.
Mm. Well, have you roped yourself in?
To your life sentence. Me. I'm getting it too.
We're riding together.
I'm doing six, but really three.
We ride together.
I'm coming out in good behavior in 2.5.
You're a dickhead.
That's what you believe, boy.
Talking about community service, anyway.
What, community service?
I can spray paint walls, put away rubbish on the highway with my high vis jacket and
I'm so done.
With the pick, you know the pick they have?
Those people will come and find you.
Hey, what people?
Fam.
They'll come revenge.
I'll be on probation. I'll come and see people like you talking about, yo, G, I went to job service.
Yeah.
I mean, not job service. What's it called? Job center. Job center.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, you know. I'm still on this road thing though, because
it's hard out here, you know what I mean, like I'm a felon though. What are you going to do what can you do for me, miss, what can you do for me?
Miss,
everyday miss, are you alright, miss? Yeah,
I think, isn't that what a girl called, the women correctional officers,
that's how they talk in prison.
Mm. Oh,
so
miss.
Yeah, so whenever, like, it's what I noticed, whenever someone came out of prison, it's like, I'll be like, oh, don't call me miss please, they'll be like, no, I can't help it, like in prison, that's how you address women.
Just imagine your CEO was buff.
Do you know? I don't, that was me. Don't ever get it twisted.
No, CEO.
Your community officer, correctional officer
in prison.
I mean, we don't have that.
I know someone that was actually in a serious relationship with one of their.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's like Titch, isn't it? Remember he was sleeping with
their.
Wow.
Was he?
Yeah.
Oh, good
deal. Yeah.
Enjoyment.
Hmm? Mm. Listen.
I mean, he's been there for a very long time.
Yeah.
She was married as well.
Long.
She was married.
She's married?
Yeah.
Oh.
This story's old, man. It came out like...
It was in the newspaper,
right? Yeah, last year or the year before.
Last year.
Oh, really? I didn't catch that.
I remember that.
He didn't even know about Thingy and his case.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Who's?
You know who? From last week. the MCs that we spoke
about. Oh, you didn't? Yeah. A lot of the thing.
I thought you knew.
Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah.
You know what the thing is, though? I don't think people knew.
No, people knew, because that was like...
When I was younger, I knew. When I was younger, I knew,
I'm from South and I knew.
I did not know.
That was proper news.
You know what I heard, yeah? Obviously, we haven't said the name in it, so can I talk about it?
Yeah.
Basically, what I got told is he didn't...
Wait, whisper it to me first and I'll let you know if you should. Don't incriminate yourself.
I'm not incriminating
myself. No, but it's a closed case.
Okay, cool.
This was years back.
He's already been out and come back.
Don't incriminate yourself.
I mean, been in and come out.
Under rules.
Oh, I'm not going to.
Okay, cool.
No, but what I got told was he didn't... Basically, he just got ahead of the girl. And
how old was the girl?
Because she was underage.
Oh, yeah.
But he didn't know that she was underage.
Yeah, and it got it's classed as statutory rape, isn't it?
Yeah, statutory. Yeah, statutory rape, sexual assault.
Oof. The other person, full force.
Oh no.
But why did she go and tell the police that she got raped?
I didn't ask that.
Well, I don't think you have to tell the police you got raped. You just tell the police that you did sexual acts with a person older.
What was her motivation for going to them?
How do we know?
You might have heard from the roadside.
From the roadside.
Risky roadside.
Nah, the risky roadside. I got
from the roadside.
That's all I got told.
The what, sorry?
I said that's all I got told.
Okay.
That's such a pity, man.
Yeah. Sticky one still, but yeah. Sticky. NBA free agency.
It's basketball, man.
This is the new segment. The segment is called "This is Basketball, Man."
Yeah.
All right, so free agency has been...
We're talking about it a bit late, though.
Yeah, because... I never thought about it until today.
Yeah, fair enough.
Free agency's been lit. All right, no, we'll talk about it like this.
Lit.
Who are your top three? Because now it's like a duo league, isn't it?
Yeah.
Who are your top three duos in the league right now? I saw Stephen A's one and it looked higgy to me. Yeah. So Stephen A, he had LeBron and AD
at
number one. Then he had Clay and Steph as number two.
Bros, they're still Smash Bros.
Not number two.
Then
he had PG and Kawhi as three.
No.
KD and Kyrie as four.
Yeah, but KD's out and, for a year.
Russell Westbrook and James Harden as five.
There's
no way Westbrook that Steph and Clay are that high. I'm sorry.
Westbrook and Harden.
They'd probably be number five now.
No, but Westbrook and Harden, the problem is that their game is incompatible at the moment.
They're very similar.
Like they're both ball
and
holders.
And we're together.
Yeah.
So for now, based on their actual name,
but
cool.
Smash Bros.
They're not Smash Brothers, the Splash Brothers.
No, sorry, the Splash Brothers.
Yeah, no, they're good.
Yeah.
But I'm taking...
Because I'm looking at technically...
Yeah, they're great shooters. They're the greatest shoot backcourt of all time. I'm taking Kawhi and PG over Steph and Clay. I'm sorry.
Honestly, they're literally just like a black Air Force.
I'm taking Kyrie and KD over the Splash Brothers.
Yeah,
I'm
Kyrie
sorry.
And KD when KD is good.
Yeah, no,
right now,
you know,
there's no point even putting
it's not about
yet.
No, it's not about whether or not they're injured or whatever. It's just about who is the better parent.
Okay. Yeah, I would put... Yeah, LeBron and
to me,
AD.
They're
literally the two best two-way players in the league.
Who? PG and Kawhi?
Yeah.
So what, for you, they're top?
They're number one, yeah.
You put them number one?
Yeah, I put them number one.
Nah, because for me, LeBron is better than Kawhi and AD is better than PG. So there's no way they can be number one to me.
I just don't need to see them play together, though.
So to me, it's...
Actually, no, yeah. I'm going off PG having two functioning shoulders, actually.
To me, it's Bron and AD.
But
Bron is still the GOAT right now. Then you've got Kawhi and PG. But Kyrie and KD is a lethal combination. So it's hard. You know what? Okay, fuck it. I'm going to go LeBron and AD. Then I'm going to go Kyrie and Durant. Nah. Because Durant is arguably...
Yeah, Durant is...
The best player.
Best player in the world right now.
Yeah, you could...
Well, not right now. He's injured, but you know what I mean.
You could... But there is an argument to say that he is the best
player. Yeah,
he's
so
the best.
So then third, I'll put Kawhi and PG.
Okay.
Then I'll put... The Splash Brothers. Then I'll put Harden and
yeah, because Harden and Westbrook, I'm not sure how they're going to play together. I'm not sure how that matching is going to work, especially with the other players in Houston. I'm not sure how that's going to work.
But this free agency has been
fucking
sick.
Fantastic.
The best free agency ever.
Do you know the best? It's going to be 21-22.
When Giannis is free, isn't it?
When Giannis is free.
Nah, it ain't going to be
LeBron.
LeBron's not going nowhere.
No, I'm saying Giannis is going to be free. LeBron.
LeBron, but he's not going to go anywhere.
No,
he's not going to make it exciting.
But it's going to be exciting. The same way that everyone thought, my God, where is Kawhi going?
Yeah.
Is he going
to
the
because
Lakers?
He was actually going to go somewhere. Yeah. But LeBron's not going to go anywhere.
No, you don't know.
No, we know.
We don't know.
He's not going to play for a fourth team. He's done. Lakers is him.
No, you don't know, man.
Bam, he's 34 years old.
In 18 months' time, you don't know what happened.
No, I get you. You can't predict the future, but I'm saying I don't think LeBron's going anywhere.
To
where?
Where's he going? 21-22, it will be...
No. You're forgetting, the Lakers have AD. That's LeBron's ticket to rings. All we have to do is keep bringing players to him.
Yeah.
Where's he gonna go?
That's true.
Look, if LeBron wants to beat Jordan, he just stay in the Lakers, let AD carry him and whoever else.
Oof.
I'm lying. All he needs is three rings to. No, he needs two more, to draw with Kobe. And then
how many does he have now? Three.
Three.
Yeah.
Two with Miami, one with Cleveland.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
Look at Gina. I think yawn.
I'll bring you in a break.
But all right. So hold on.
Okay, your list is sounding a bit
Yeah.
But Stephen A's got bare emotion in it sometimes.
Yeah. He'll do the best of emotion.
He's the press Knicks fan like me.
Yeah,
so.
But nah.
Listen, the Knicks he was
that the day after the draft lottery, he was finished. His heart was every Knicks fan was
because you know what it is before the draft and before the free agency was Zion, KD, and Kyrie. That was the dream.
But this is what I'm not trying to understand why the Knicks people were so convinced, because you guys had the same odds as the other two.
Yeah, but the odds are just a guess.
But then every Knicks fan got so emotionally attached.
There was literally a hashtag for tank for Zion, basically, to literally say they're literally gonna tank, everyone was trying to tank, just to make sure they get him. Do you know what I mean? And then it not happening after literally they gave up halfway through the season.
But look at this. Fucking Barrett's a good player though.
Yeah, he is.
Arguably, he's a bit. Well, I was hearing a lot of people say that arguably.
Yeah, I was hearing that he's better than Zion. Yeah, just that Zion is
the box office
attraction.
Yeah,
and
you have to have a name.
And he's dunking at the gym.
Yeah.
But all round player.
Why is he built like that though? He's built like he's 36 years old.
He's built like a big man.
Yeah, it's just weird.
Because that's what I'm also worried about, his knees. His knees at that age, he has to lose at least 20-30
But listen, there's a lot of teams I'm going to watch this season. A lot.
I'm buying the whole league pass, bro.
I'm watching the Pelicans. Yeah,
I'm having the whole league pass.
Pelicans look dope.
I'm watching Lakers. Clippers. Right now, I support LA.
Of course you do.
I support LA.
Fucking big.
So just whoever is doing the bits. The funny thing is, I don't mind Rockets winning the title.
Mm.
I don't mind Clippers winning it. I don't mind Lakers winning it. I don't mind Bucks winning it. Because I like all those players.
Because I like Giannis. I love Giannis.
I like all those players. You know what I mean?
The only thing I'm a bit... This is going to sound stupid, but I'm a bit annoyed with him. The fact that it's he's doing all this promotion for
Giannis.
Yeah. But there's literally zero mention of his Nigerian heritage. And it's a bit jarring considering...
No, I don't think there's zero mention.
Mate,
It's literally zero mention apart from
on the sole of his shoe, right? It just says, I am my father's legacy or something like that. And then that's it.
Yeah, him being Nigerian rarely comes up.
It doesn't come up. He literally got the tracksuit and the World Cup kit last year and literally that was it.
No, I've watched interviews when he talks about being Nigerian.
I'm talking about the actual promotion.
To me,
yeah, but that's not his fault. That's the narrative that the Bucks and the NBA.
It's not.
And the reason why he was called the Greek Freak is because they couldn't pronounce Antetokounmpo.
Yeah,
of course.
So that's why they're well, we're gonna call him Giannis or Greek Freak.
How about the Niger Freak?
Yeah.
He's Greek. He has a Greek passport. He didn't have a Nigerian
passport. So I'm
he's Greek by nationality. I guess that's what they
I'm British, but I'm Nigerian, so what?
Hello.
But it brings fans in it. Greek fans are loving the Bucks now, so.
Yeah.
But there's more Nigerians than there's Greek people.
Where?
You know how big Nigeria is?
There's more Nigerians than Greek people in
the population of Nigeria is massive. What are you talking about?
There's more.
No, I'm not talking about in the States. What Nigerians are fucking watching NBA?
Yes, they are.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, bro.
They definitely are. Hakeem Olajuwon brought, not widely.
I don't know who has the biggest fan base, but I know Nigerians watch the NBA.
Yeah, but I'm saying not widely.
Do. How do you know? We don't know this for facts.
Okay, cool.
No, we don't. This is a guessing game, no?
No, they definitely, well, from what I know, Nigerians do like.
But can I just say,
I'm not saying they don't, but I'm saying not widely, right?
But
they're even looking at where they're going to watch it.
I'm talking about the internet, mine. But can I just say that his family, three out of the four brothers are in the NBA.
Yeah,
The Lakers got
his younger brother.
Alec, what's his name?
I can't remember his name. And then the other brother plays for the Bucks.
Costas.
As well.
No. Yeah.
Yes, he does.
Costas
One of them plays for the Bucks and one of them plays for the Lakers.
That's weird.
So Costas just got way to Lakers. Thanasis is now at the Bucks.
Yeah.
And then they've got another brother.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's a basketball player, that one.
Well, he's young now. He's still 14, 15, the youngest one.
No, he doesn't. No. Okay,
maybe. There's another four boys.
There's five then.
Yeah, there's loads of boys.
Yeah. Their parents must be really
But I was watching a documentary.
His dad's dead.
I was watching a documentary. He still lives in a two-bedroom apartment.
Who?
Giannis. With his mom, his girlfriend.
Oh, is it?
And his brother. I was like, how's this working out?
He's doing bits, bro.
Bro, I'm not sure how this is
saving all my money.
Bruv. Because they were, it made 22 million last year before the night.
But our next season is going to be fucking lit.
Yeah, it's going to be
fantastic. I actually can't wait.
Next season is going to be lit. The NBA.
But then the Bucks, I'm thinking.
But can I just say, the Lakers.
Middleton's gone, no?
No, he's still there.
Do you know what's so funny?
The Lakers built a good team, though. Everyone's forgetting they've got Boogie and they've got
Boogie Cousins.
Danny Green.
Yeah,
those are two good additions. No, yeah.
Danny Green's a shooter.
Two good additions.
And who else have they got now?
Do you know what? Because it didn't start off like that, though. Because initially,
they had five Rondo. People on their roster.
Yeah, they didn't start off like that. So it was all looking sticky.
They had five people on their roster.
Of course.
Yeah, but do you think they're going to end up like that? Obviously,
of course, but
listen,
all of the options were in the way.
Got Kyle Kuzma.
Yeah, Kuzma.
Kuzma.
I don't rate him, though.
Rondo.
They got Rondo, yeah.
McGee. Boogie.
Don't forget my man.
Green.
Don't forget my man.
Contavious Caldwell-Pope.
Yeah, what's his name?
He looks like an old man. Even though he's like Caruso.
They got Caruso. That's the one that he looks about 80, but he's really 25.
Yeah. Is he 25?
How are they age so much?
He's very young.
All these players.
No, I think he's younger than 25, actually. Yeah. He's got no hair.
Because even Caldwell Pope is under 30, but always looking old.
Yeah. And then they've got, who else have they got? They've got that guy who looks like Elmer Fudd. What's his name, man? The one who came from the Brooklyn Nets. The chubby light skinned Don, the bald head. Can't be his name. Anyway, they got him.
Oh, yeah. He was at the Nets.
Yeah. And they got one slot left that they're going to try and get Iguodala.
Can't believe
for a trade.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll see. But Lakers are looking good.
I like Iguodala, though.
Yeah.
He was playoffs.
Yeah. So, NBA looking sick, man. All right, Gina, you can come back now.
Gina, you catch up with Breaking Bad.
I'm still on season two.
Still on season two?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not watching it as consistently as everything else. So where am I up to?
Have you watched Breaking Bad? Armor of God.
What's that, cheeks?
Huh? Listen, this is holy water. Sip.
All right, so far, who's your favorite character? Have you guys watched Breaking Bad before this?
Listen,
I've watched like
Phase 4 got announced, big man.
Wait, relax.
Is Breaking Bad the one where he's making meth?
Making crack cocaine. Listen, Phase 4, Gina, are you in?
What?
Marvel Phase 4.
Oh, okay. Where's the new film?
Phase 4.
Oh, I get it. No. Listen, so obviously, we had the.
This is a fucking big deal, bro. Hold on.
It's a new season, basically, isn't it? Marvel.
What season?
You know how, like, we had.
Listen,
Endgame,
Marvel Phase 4 has been announced, big man. It's going down.
So Infinity War.
Fucking
was the last
Blade,
one,
bitch.
No. Endgame is the last
Shang-Chi,
one.
Shang-Chi, bitch.
Okay.
Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. Are you mad, bro?
The next film.
Yeah. That's going to be dope. It's gonna be proper.
The Eternals.
Oh, you know what? You need to end that way.
Four, Love and Thunder.
You're bare annoying.
What else is there?
Brienne of Tarth.
Wed Brienne.
Brienne of fucking Tarth. Nah, all right, cool.
I'm not gonna lie, I miss Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
I miss waking up really, really, really early in the morning to watch it.
Marvel Phase 4 has been announced, and I'm gassed, but I'm not as gassed.
It's not as exciting
as I would have been because I'm not really into the Disney Plus shows, even though I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
And they didn't announce Black Panther 2, they didn't announce Guardians 3, they didn't announce
they all coming.
Spider-Man 3.
Kevin Feige announced that.
Yeah, they're coming, but they didn't make it a part of the display.
I don't really care about
the announcement. Yeah, so I do care. Okay. I want to see the names and titles next to each other with the years. Okay.
What's this about? Sorry.
It's about Marvel, the announcement.
The new season.
Of what?
A new season.
Not a season, bro.
You know
it's
what I mean? But it's like a new season.
Basically, they've got a bunch of new movies coming out and they've got like these Disney Plus shows as well, which are going to like tie into the films.
I see.
So you've got Loki's program, you've got WandaVision, you've got Hawkeye.
And Winter Soldier.
Falcon and Winter Soldier. That's going to be lit still. I'm excited. Blade, I'm surprised about.
Yeah. That announcement was so sick because basically what they did.
I don't know any of this.
You know about Blade? But he's black, no black power, all that stuff.
Oh, Blade, what, the guy with the leather jacket?
Yeah.
Wesley Snipes? He's back.
No, he's not going to be Wesley Snipes.
It's going to be Marshall Ali.
That name's hard, you know.
I love him.
Marshall Ali.
Who's Marshall Ali? Who's that?
That name is hard, bro.
He's in the Green Book.
He's Cottonmouth from Luke Cage.
Have
you seen, what do you call it? What's that film? Moonlight.
The worst thing is, I have a feeling I know who you're talking about.
Have you seen Moonlight?
Yeah.
Personally, I think he's a perfect...
He's sexy, bro.
But the announcement was so sick.
Is that in his 40s?
Ain't that sexy? Calm down.
He's like 46.
Ain't that sexy?
He's very sexy. You know, like the older man.
Oh yeah, I had a feeling it would be him.
Did you?
Mahershala.
Yeah.
He was psychic, huh?
He's the guy. He's in he's Moonlight, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah, no, it's looking good still. What film are you excited for the most?
He's all right.
Probably Thor: Love and Thunder. You know?
Done though, with Jane Foster as a female Thor.
Yeah, that's gonna be dope.
It's going
man.
Down.
All of this sounds hella complicated to me.
It's gonna be so
complicated.
Good.
It's just.
And the thing is, the director Taika Waititi. He's like, what he's done. They've literally saved the Thor franchise with the third.
Oh yeah, of course.
Because the first two films were just rubbish. They tanked. Well, they didn't tank.
I don't think 4-1 was that bad. I mean, no, I liked 4-1.
I didn't.
People are bashing 4-1.
I didn't really like it.
4-2 was swag.
Yeah, 4-2. The first two were nothing compared to Ragnarok. Anyway, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, Ragnarok was a complete new.
It was sick. They literally saved that franchise on their third go kind of thing, and now they can literally kind of go wherever they want with it. You know what I mean?
No, so, they can.
Yeah, that's gonna be dope, man.
Beta
Ray Bill potentially in it, because remember his sculpture was on the wall
in
Ragnarok kind of thing. So yeah, man.
Looking forward to him.
Doctor Strange and Thingy and Scarlet Witch film is gonna be mad though, because
apparently it's the first horror that Marvel gonna do.
Because in theory,
look at these two, are like, what the fuck are these guys talking about?
In theory, that's
it's Marvel, man.
In theory, that film should be like 5 minutes long, because them two teaming up together is just, it's dumb. Like, there's like, they really shouldn't lose to anyone.
So, Gina.
Really.
All right. What's up with the nerd talk? Look at Brent. Yo, Brent, you need to come and tell us about Croatia later, though. No?
He said he's not interested.
Why?
I have a deadline.
Got a deadline. Look at Brent.
I haven't even slept yet. My man took his 52 podcast.
Look at Brent talking about, I got a deadline. It's not school, man.
Bro, he's got a business to run, man.
I'm playing, bro. I'm playing. But yeah, no, I'm looking forward to this story. All right, sorry, girls. All right, we're back.
Yeah.
What's on the docket, guys? Cheers.
Yeah, what's on the docket? Your bear trying to sip this water like it's alcohol.
No, I'm just
cheers.
I'm messing around. Gina, what's on the docket, love?
Docket, hold on. I'm coming.
Did I sing there?
Why are you laughing?
Why? Because I always put you under this docket pressure.
No, I do. That's why. It's fine.
I find it funny.
All right, cool. How would you respond to this text from an ex?
Oh, that one.
Yeah. I'm getting married tomorrow. So it says, hi, is this still Alexa's number? Yes, who's this? Someone something, remember me. She's like, oh, what the fuck? Laugh out loud. What's up, dude? I'm getting married tomorrow. I wanted to send you this message. My fiance knows I'm sending this to you. Thank you for being my first love. Thank you for always encouraging me. Thank you for keeping me out of trouble.
It's okay.
Thank you for, this is a guy sending it to
you. Oh.
Thank you for keeping me out of trouble. Thank you for times you took care of me when I was sick and depressed. Thank you for loving me. If you haven't already, I hope you one day find love. If you loved me that much when we were young, I can only imagine how strong and powerful your love is now. The way your heart is made is amazing. I know we were only kids when we dated, but you taught me what love is. To the man who is lucky enough to have you as their wife, I hope he treats you with care. I hope he knows who he has in front of him. I hope he shows you love and loyalty every day. You deserve that and more. My point in all of this is you are the reason why I know how to love someone. You taught me love. You taught me how to deal with my anger, how to deal with my depression, and how to live life to the fullest. And I'm grateful for you. I wish you love and happiness.
Fuck off.
I wouldn't be mad at that text.
I wouldn't be mad, but it slightly sounds like you're the one that got away. Like,
no,
very much
no,
so.
I don't no, think it no. is.
Why
no,
send that text?
No, I don't think it's the one that got away. I think you basically saying that you just learned from me. Like,
no, but it's like, why would you even think to send that?
Because you want to tell that person you were a great person.
No, that's like,
no,
that's,
I learned so much from you.
But loads of people are like, bro, you marrying the wrong person. Yeah.
No,
like,
I don't think it is. I think in.
For you still
it
have
that they were young.
Feel that way about that person.
No, but I think I've had guys that I've dated, and after a year or two, they'll come back, you know, you were a good woman. And for me, I appreciate that, because sometimes when someone breaks up with you and you feel like, was it because of this? Was it because of that? I personally wouldn't be that mad, because it sounds like there's been a break, right?
You know what it is? Okay, I'll take back my earlier fuck off. I think it kind of depends on how that relationship ended and how you feel about that person.
No, but even if the relationship ended bad, if this was like 5-6 years ago, I'm hoping that I'm now in a space where that shit isn't going to trigger me, because anything's going to trigger
because,
me.
Because, for example,
if I'm still not over it,
because if,
I would appreciate that. If someone's saying,
if my
you
first
were a good
ex
woman, I just didn't
text me that
you.
Message, I'd be like, I feel good about it.
Yeah, I wouldn't be mad.
But it depends who sends me the message. Yeah. I'll be honest with you.
Yeah, because you're not over it.
But I'm like, I think I'll be happy because I'm thinking, damn right, bitch.
Yeah.
Damn right.
I'm like, yeah.
Now go get married.
Yeah, like, you're a good person. And I didn't appreciate you, but somebody else.
Yeah.
My whole thing is that, like, him saying, oh, yeah, my fiance knows that I'm sending this kind of thing, yeah.
And I even
he knows that it can come across.
Yeah, and I even
Of course, but even then, personally, like, I'm the kind of person, once I move on, then I move on. Regardless of how I feel about, oh yeah, you know, if there's no bad blood, whatever, that's fine. But I don't need to go back and tell you that. Like, if we knew when it was done, like, how we both felt, kind of, even if it ended on bad terms, kind of thing, like, we both kind of know how we felt. I don't need to go back and tell you those things. Do you know what I mean? Like,
share a joke.
Nah, it's bread. It's mean bread. Private joke.
What about you,
G? Do you know what I mean? Like, even out of respect for my current partner, I'm not going to go back and start saying, oh, yeah, you know, you taught me that. I'm not going to lie. I'm not really with
my
that.
My man ain't sending that to his ex.
That's nonsense.
Today,
I'm going to do
tomorrow,
that.
Next year.
You ain't going to know, boo.
No. In this situation, he's in my fiance knows, isn't it?
Yeah, but that's true. But in a normal situation, why are you telling your fiance?
I'd feel more comfortable. In fact, I'd feel probably more comfortable going to my current partner and say, okay, yeah, the last person I was with, this is how it ended, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And this is how, you know, I felt at the time, but, you know, I'm with you kind of thing and it's done now. But I don't need to go back and tell the other person, okay, I've moved on, and but thank you, all this kind of thing, because it's ended.
I'm not going to lie, it depends on who...
Yeah, who it's from.
Who it's from.
Yeah.
But regardless, I'd still find it a bit cheeky though, yeah. Because do you know what the maddest thing is?
Yeah.
I don't need your reassurance, bitch.
Yeah.
I know I'm lit.
That's
and I'm, like, I don't need you to confirm what I already know. Mm. It's like, okay, cool, that it's taken you 10 years to come to this conclusion. Good for you. Keep that to yourself.
People always,
do you get what I mean?
It's people, like, always come to realization anyway.
Yeah, it's just about when. So what do you want me to do now? Now you've told
it's
me
true
this.
Though.
Am I meant to say thank you? Like, yep. Thank you for your kind words. No, like.
Everyone eventually.
They do.
The thing is, if you were shit in a relationship,
fam,
you eventually realize.
I'm going to be honest, yeah, and it's true. If you are a good person and a guy does shit to you, yeah, people will always come to the realization
and say,
yep.
She was
and
a good
say,
woman. Yeah.
Even what's it called? Yeah, I was at Pitch last year, yeah.
Yeah.
And the guy I used to date came up to me and was like, yo, like, but I apologize. And I said, fam, it's minor. Like, I don't care. Yeah. Like, he's like, no, I'm so sorry. Like, you were so good to me. I said, it's all right. I mean, what do you want to do with this information? Yeah. It's like, okay, thanks. But I don't, like, I'm so past it.
Yeah.
I don't need, just because you want to make yourself feel better, because that's all, realistically, this is all it is. It's just about you being at peace with it and you making yourself feel better.
Yeah.
I got peace
ages
ago. That's
100% rep.
Because, it's selfish.
Because I didn't.
Because it's all about you.
Because I've been in a situation where I've actually spoken to an ex. The only difference is that Me and her were actually cool. Like, even though after we broke up, we're still friends now, kind of thing. But we were friends, like, pretty much after the breakup, kind of thing. And I don't know, a few months down the line, I realized, okay, do you know what? Yeah, I did so many, like, shitty things. I was shitty in this situation where it needs to be, kind of thing. But while we were still friends, kind of thing, one day I just said, okay, we need to talk, kind of thing. And I just told her everything, exactly how I felt. But that was fine because I wasn't seeing her at the time, she wasn't seeing her at the time, kind of thing. But you know, it was to be honest, it was for myself. It was selfish, but I had to let her know in it, kind of thing. But even after that, we're still fine, kind of thing. But I'm not going to wait a year, 2 years, 3 years, where everyone's moved on, kind of thing.
A lie?
That's so...
5 years, I'm not lying.
You're about to get married, so clearly...
I'm not even thinking about you.
Yeah. So maybe it was something that he felt like, I just need to do it before I move in.
He's not over it. I don't think he's over it.
He's not over it.
He's not over it, man.
Not over it.
There's no way he can be over it.
I'm not going to lie. You see that message here? It's like, you want a response. And he went in. Like, you didn't
full
even need
dissertation.
To go.
You were reading for like 5 minutes.
Bruv.
I'm thinking, when is she going to stop?
He was so specific. He went in like it was a freaking love letter.
Yeah, I guess, but because you're looking at it from the girlfriend's perspective. So you're looking at if you were his girl.
No. I'm looking at it as someone on the receiving end.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Obviously, I don't know. I wouldn't be.
Like, I don't need. Do you know what it is? I don't need. Like,
yeah, so
I'm seeing. I think
like,
it's.
Okay, cool.
I think
if you're
it's,
sure,
I think
if you're sure
selfish.
Of yourself, yeah, you'll know. Like, well,
that's
if,
what I'm saying.
If they're telling you these things, you already know it.
Yeah, so you're just gonna be like, okay, cool, that's nice.
Yeah, the thing is, it's whatever. I'll read it. I'm like, cool, I appreciate it, but
gonna,
I ain't gonna really give you like a detailed response.
Some people,
back.
Some people will come and respond with hella passion. I'm like, I wouldn't be angry.
Yeah, I'll be like,
no, the response wouldn't be angry.
I'll be like, do you know what? I will literally send you a thumbs up.
The handshake emoji.
Oh,
yeah,
literally.
No, a handshake or
but yeah,
up.
I wouldn't respond with.
I'd be like, thanks.
Some of the comments I saw, people like, I was like, no, I just wouldn't. Like, it's cool, isn't it? Like, yeah, you said what you said.
Yeah, yeah.
I knew I was a dope woman anyway, but it's nice that you've finally come to this realization, and I hope you can live with it and cool.
Yeah, but you're getting married, so what does it?
Yeah, so
it
doesn't really make a difference. So that, and hopefully, I've also moved on.
Even if, cool. even if I haven't moved on yet.
Hopefully, you know.
I hope.
Even if I haven't moved on, you're still getting the handshake and the thumbs up, bruv.
Yeah.
Move.
Yeah.
Don't come and disturb my slumber.
That reminds me of Entourage when Vince. Remember when he was finally? I think it was the last season where he actually liked the blonde girl that he eventually got with.
Yeah.
And he made a video where he was talking to all his exes, talking about how...
And you sent it out to all of them.
Yeah, I was a dog, I treated you badly, but I'm a changed man now. And you sent the video to all of his exes, all the girls he ever dealt with.
Victory!
Because he finally found a girl that, you know, changed him and made him, you know...
You know, I used to rewatch that, man.
Entourage is the greatest show I've ever made.
Yeah. You're the one that brought me in there.
People
remember.
Give really good reviews.
It is amazing. No, it's so funny.
Entourage is the greatest show
ever. It is so funny.
But yeah, no, I wouldn't... Personally, for me, I would never do that. That's just not my...
Yeah, I wouldn't do it either.
I would do. But if someone sent it to me, I'd be like, cool, I appreciate it, but
yeah,
it depends who it's from.
Be mad.
And depends, yeah, it depends who it's from. But either way, if someone's saying good things about me, I'm not going to be like, oh, fuck you.
I'll never be mad though, even if I'm bitter.
Yeah, I'll be mad. Because you're saying good things. Yeah.
Even if I still feel some type of way, like if I'm not over it or over you, obviously I'm going to feel some type of way about it. But
yeah, no.
I'm saying I'm still...
If you're not over it, then that's a slap in the face because one, they're telling you I'm getting married. Not only that, but you were great to me. Like, you should have realized this then, you prick.
Yeah.
I'm alive.
No, but it's good if someone's not realizing just to leave. Like,
what do you mean?
No, in terms of him.
Yeah.
The guy. If you didn't realize that at that time, then maybe it was best because I'm not going to wait 10 years for you to now realize.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like, fuck that.
No, you got to.
You got to bounce.
Got to bounce, baby.
Got to bounce.
Okay. Where did you find that?
It was on Instagram. Well, I always find stuff.
Oh,
on Instagram.
On Instagram.
And now. In other news, coming straight from Knickers Ain't Shit.
What's this? A podcast?
Hey.
Hi. Oh, Lord.
I want to invite you to my baby shower. Oh, okay. When is it? Next Saturday. Please dress nicely. I'm going to present you as our child's godmother. Huh? Your girlfriend's okay with your ex being the godmother.
You didn't even ask me
how I felt about this. Like, do you think I want to be your child's godmother? Question mark. You love kids and I wouldn't trust nobody around mine except you. And maybe we can still fuck here and there.
Whoa!
Damn.
Okay, do you know what? He's got a point still.
What?
Do you know what? Yeah,
no problem.
Let me learn. Forgive me like this, yeah?
No problem.
If he trusts her and she's actually a good person, she's good with kids, yeah?
Mm.
You know, the dick is payment, isn't it?
What? Who wants your dick as payment?
What is going on?
Because you know, do you know godparents that like, if the child die, if the parents die, you are kind of like responsible for the kids.
I'm joking. No, he's actually taking the piss. But like,
where do he's taking the piss?
Hold on.
I don't think that's a real conversation.
He's making his link.
He's making his ex girlfriend.
The godmother of his child.
That's mad. And still offering dick.
Listen, he wants the best of both worlds. The best of both worlds. No, he's moving mad still. But the thing is, people do have good relationships with their exes.
No, not to be doing godmum
Kamori Simmons, Russell.
She's moving mad though. She is in general.
You know, those son that shared with Visit Digimon. I can't say his name. Digimon.
Oh, Jimon.
Jimon.
Give us three.
It's Jimon Monsu.
Jimon Monsu.
Jimon.
Russell. Digimon. What's his name? Not
it
Russell.
Can never be Jimon. It's Jimon.
Okay, sorry.
It's Jimon.
Yeah, sorry.
What is his name?
Jimon Hunt?
No.
Oh, Russell.
It's not Russell. Is it Russell?
We're talking about the ex.
Russell Simmons.
Yeah.
Well, it is.
What's Russell Simmons' name?
He's the godfather.
Yeah, Russell Simmons.
No, he's the godfather to their son.
That's a mad thing. That can never happen.
Yeah, because Russell Simmons is like a guru.
But I mean,
to your ex-wife's new son with her new husband.
Yeah, that's all mad.
I can never.
But he's godfather to
I can't.
Do you know what that's called?
What?
Maturity.
Maturity. I knew you were gonna say that.
Nah.
It's called maturity. And the thing is,
Kamora and
Russell's relationship is so cool.
Yeah.
You don't have other cool people.
What?
You don't have other cool people.
No, that I can trust my children. No. So I'm gonna trust the father of my other kids to be the godfather of my new kid.
Like, he got money.
And he's got money too. It's a smart move, Kamora.
I wouldn't.
Round of applause.
I wouldn't.
You know what I mean? And I'm sure you've got girls who you dealt with before who you're proper safe with now, innit? That you could trust with that type of thing. Innit?
You'd make them your kids.
No,
godmother.
not to that extent, but
I wouldn't make them my kids' godmother, but I can definitely trust them. Yeah,
yeah. You've got girls who you slept with in the past godmother. Who are like proper tight with you, or
yeah.
And who knows how it can progress down the years?
No,
and then,
I don't think.
And then you forget about the fact that you're still with her back then. It just becomes an afterthought. Trust
no,
me.
No, I understand that. I understand still having friendships. I'm not even saying don't have a friendship. Cool, if we're mature enough to get to that point.
Yeah.
But not to make my kids their godchildren. Nah.
Yeah.
And maturity in friendship, I'm not even saying no. Because I'm not for people saying.
Do you have any male friends who slept with in the past and right now it's not sexual, you're just completely cool, great as friends?
Very.
And do you even think about your history, them sexually?
No.
Not at all?
Not at all.
So you couldn't make that person a good father? Because you're always going to remember the sex?
No, out of respect for my partner.
Okay, true.
To be like, I'm not trying to bring that into the situation.
That's where I get it, because of the respect for the partner.
Yeah, I wouldn't. I just wouldn't.
I mean, we had a conversation about this.
I wouldn't make... No. I'm not trying to make... You think I'd make my kids with that person?
That's fair enough.
Never.
Yeah, no. I get it. Never. Out of respect for
we can still be friends, and there's that maturity level.
Yeah.
But, I mean, but even then, he's not having it anyway, so there's no point.
No, that's true. That is mad. And he still wants to fuck as well. So he wants to cheat.
Yeah, he's still trying to cheat.
And he wants to...
I think that's just a fake text, man. There's no way someone's going
to... No, niggas ain't shit these days. Trust me.
You think that's a fake text? Listen, I've...
Niggas...
It's the way he's worded it. It's like, you know, if you think you can beat, like, well, if you think you can still beat, you don't really put it across that way, do you?
I know. Some niggas are...
I've never said, oh yeah, we can still fuck.
Man. Yeah, like, no, not like that.
No, you know what it is? I realise... From talking to different girls here, like friends, and them telling me about how guys move to them, I realized that everyone has a different type of game.
It's true that.
And some niggas are saying some shit that I would never say.
Yeah, and they're getting away with it.
And some niggas are doing shit that I would never. I'm thinking, this is what niggas are out here saying. Shit. The game is different.
Got my
And it's funny when girls are telling me about guys that I know.
Yeah.
I'm thinking.
The way they're moving, isn't
it? Right, you just give me all the juice, huh? Now, niggas out here moving mad. Even I've got friends who I get moved to by celebrities and they're telling me about how the celebs are moving to them.
Really?
Yeah. I'm like, bruv. And the thing is, one girl in particular, she's not even having it. I'm like, big man, go secure the bag, bruv.
Is it A-list celebrity? A or B?
Like a... Okay, hold on. I'll write both celebrities down that I've recently been told about.
UK or US?
No, both US.
Really?
Yeah, and she's not giving...
She's not having it?
Not giving them any play, hold on.
But I think maybe she also knows that it's not.
That's the first one.
Let me see.
Nah, but I wouldn't have it from him.
You don't have it from him?
Nah.
Let me see.
Cringe. I wouldn't have it from him.
But that's definitely securing the bag.
And then
though.
The second one is.
Girl.
The daddy is.
How the fuck do you spell his second name?
Ah, the second name's involved. But if it's mad, if you put it in someone, I'm seeing him, Lara.
Who are you seeing that's a celebrity? Huh? Do tell.
No, both of these people I'd never have it with. This one.
Not after his.
This
before. If this was before that whole saga, I would have.
What's that? Oh, okay.
You can't have it, bro.
No, I can't have it now though.
No?
Oh, there you go.
And he looks like a newt.
Hey, is this the fashion thing?
Mm.
Hold on, what team is he at now?
I don't know yet.
He's a free agent.
Free agent.
Yeah,
so guys, what are we saying about Nicole Murphy?
I don't think he gives a fuck.
He can't getting caught with that director.
Yeah, the married man.
Talking about, that's how we say hello.
Fam. No. Yeah. But apparently, she cheated on Lisa Ray's ex-husband.
Wait, no. Can I say something?
Yeah.
Because the picture of them kissing was looking very, very suggestive.
It's intimate.
But I'll tell you this. So I had a friend, who... Obviously, to me, it looks like they've had a history.
Yeah.
Mm. I had a friend who we had history before and whatever we had ended. But whenever she saw me, she greeted me with a kiss on the lips. And then...
Whoa.
It wasn't like a smooch. It was like a...
Yeah.
Like, she's always with a kiss. And then after a while, I was like... I texted her and said, you know, you're confusing me, you know, because we don't even do that anymore, but you keep kissing me on the lips. She's like, oh, I'm sorry. Is this the way I greet you? I do it to you and another guy. It's just you two in particular who I always greet like that.
What?
I'm thinking,
on the lips.
On the lips. Yeah. I'm thinking,
you on the mouth.
I said, can you stop, please? Because you're giving me mixed signals. I don't understand what's going on between us because you keep kissing me on the lips. Mm. And according to me, like what
we're
we had
space,
was is done, but you keep kissing me on my lips and you're confusing me. So It can happen. It can happen.
Nah, fam.
I'm not saying it's happening here, but I'm not saying it's happened to me.
No, but anyway.
Cheers.
But yeah, apparently, she also, when Lisa Ray was with her husband, he had an affair with
Lisa Ray with a gooseneck ass.
you love a gooseneck.
I love a gooseneck, yeah.
Yusuf legitly does.
Yo, goosenecks are sexy, bro.
You're disgusting.
No, that gooseneck.
I'm so done right
now. Now the lion's in there.
I am.
That is so weird. No, I don't love them, but I love it on her, I'll be honest. I saw it gone.
Yeah, no, apparently when Lisa Ray was married, she cheated on, she went after her husband.
Who? Oh, what? Eddie Murphy?
Yeah, Nikki. Mm-hmm. No, Nicole Murphy went after
Lisa Ray's husband.
Lisa Ray's husband.
So who's his brother she's kissing? Oh.
He's a director. He's a film director.
Is she married?
Is that Layla Fee?
He's married.
Okay, so.
But Nikki Murphy's peng, though.
Do you remember what's that film? Boomerang.
Yeah.
The lady with the really bad toes.
She's big now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lela something. Rocha. I can't even.
Oh. I thought that was Robin Givens.
That's not Robin Givens.
I can't stand Robin Givens in that film.
No, Robin Givens isn't. That is Robin Givens from Boomerang.
No, she is, but it's not the lady that. It's not the lady that.
Oh, that's the other girl.
Yeah, it's lady with the really bad toes.
Oh yeah, yeah. They look very alike though to me.
Yeah, they do. She was so.
Can you not get off your damn phones, please?
I'm trying to find a picture of her.
Fam.
No, I'm talking to her. Yeah. I can tell she's doing. What's
her name again?
I'm working at the same time.
Business.
Yeah.
I can't remember her name. But it's a woman
this
who.
Plan
yeah.
B for secure the ring and get me. This is oh. A.
No, okay, cool. But yeah, no, I'm being serious about the styling thing though.
Yeah, I'll do it.
But I want like, I want.
You tell me your brief though.
I want high. It depends on the. On
and
the,
she apologized. And fair enough, she apologized. I want high fashion. As well.
Okay, cool.
What's that?
Nicole Murphy apologized for it, so.
That for going after Lisa Ray's husband?
No, for kissing the director.
Yeah, but she kissed him. What, did she claim that she kissed him as in a friendly way?
No,
or?
Now she's come out and apologized and said she knows that she was wrong. Mm-hmm. My man's married. But regardless, yeah, anyway. Yeah.
Oh, is that it?
What we say? Canceling her or not?
Oh.
No, I'm joking.
I don't really follow Nicole Murphy in that
Neither
way.
I don't really follow her. I don't really know what she's.
But she's sexy though.
Yeah, she's sexy. MILF time.
For the amount of kids that she's had. Ooh.
Yeah, for real.
Oh, how many kids has she got with?
Five, six.
Oh, all with. Yeah,
all with
Eddie.
They were together for time, innit?
Yeah, like 20 years.
Would you say he what that?
He secured it.
Oh.
From early.
What a shame.
Yeah, no, she's top five MILFs.
Bro,
yeah.
Sexy.
Wait,
who's top five then? Because I'd say she's top five, not.
Halle Berry.
Like, top five women's period.
Yeah, no. MILF. I think she's like number one.
Okay, her.
Is it Halle Berry, baby?
Halle Berry over Nicole Murphy?
No, not over. No, top five.
To be fair, I never really liked Halle Berry, to be fair.
Nah, Halle Berry.
I think she's very overrated. Extremely overrated.
Mm.
Yeah, she's.
Just smoking still. I don't even like that.
What is buff about Halle Berry, please?
Do you know what it is?
It's her energy, I think, more than anything.
What energy?
You've been around.
What energy?
In it.
Halle Berry hasn't got no energy, bro.
Do you know she hasn't. Vibe.
Halle Berry is the most overrated woman I've ever seen.
Joking.
No, she is. She's very overrated. What's nice about Halle Berry?
Yeah, what is great about her?
How can you ask me? What do you mean she's what's nice about Halle Berry? Look at her. What can I ask me?
I'm not saying she's ugly. She's not. She's nice.
She's a lighty. She looks like
but she's not. She's not super buff to me.
No, she is, man.
Like Nicole Murphy.
In Boomerang, she was cute. Yeah, cool. But
like, it's something glamorous.
What you telling me? You telling me Storm is buff? Nah, bruv. Storm, go and fly up and get the rain.
Yeah?
And the thunder, please.
No, you're mocking it.
Still. No, I don't think Halle Berry. No,
Halle Berry.
I've always thought.
Nice.
Like, hold on. Who are your top three overrated girls? Overrated celebs?
Overrated.
You think Rihanna's one of them, innit? You think Rihanna's overrated?
No. I think Rihanna has mad sex appeal, but I think she's overrated.
No. Mm. Rihanna is different.
Yeah. You don't feel her.
No.
When Rihanna's doing that grown woman thing.
I think Rihanna is nice, but I think she's overrated, yes. I think people gas her up too much.
I think also Rihanna's vibe.
That's what I'm saying.
No, she has mad sex
appeal. It's a vibe. It's a
and
vibe.
And her energy you can feel.
Yeah.
This Halle Berry energy.
I can feel
what? Catwoman.
Nah, I can feel Halle Berry energy.
Catwoman's got energy. What energy you got?
I can feel it still.
Obviously, Monsters Ball, she gave off the energy.
Okay.
With
that
90,
one scene yeah. in the 90s.
Back in 1991.
I guarantee
I'm
you
not
right
championing
now,
her. It's him.
I guarantee you right now, that scene wouldn't even like...
Bang now.
No.
Yeah, it would never bang. Not when Power's giving us full fucking...
No, that scene was good because of her expression. Like, she was feeling it.
She got dealt with.
By so Billy was, Billy Bob Thornton.
No, wait. So was Angela. Angela was always feeling it.
Yeah, sure.
Billy Bob Thornton.
That scene when they're having sex and there was like against the window.
Mm-hmm.
To the window.
I'm not gonna lie. Every time I saw Ghost
to the wow
back.
Even when I saw my Essence dress, I was like.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, Halle Berry's overrated. Rihanna a little bit, but I still think she's playing. Beyonce. No, I'm joking. To be fair, I don't really like Beyonce. So you agree with it?
Oh
no,
my God.
I was scared. I said it as a test up. I thought, no, I'll take it back. Okay, cool. Beyonce is there still.
Do you know what? No, honestly, the other day I was talking to my friend. I said the biggest myth that we ever sold is that Beyonce was thick.
She's really not. Yeah.
Beyonce's not thick.
No. She ain't got her back off, but she got hips.
She didn't have very high, wide hips neither.
No.
Does she?
Like, Beyonce is quite petite.
Yes.
Huh?
She is?
Yes. Where? Look at pictures of Beyonce. Honestly, even back in,
she's not big. Because
even look at the things they did in Bootylicious.
She's petite, where?
Things like Bootylicious and whatever. They dropped her trousers.
Yeah.
So
that her
ooh, that was nice. Yeah,
she ain't yeah, back. Yeah. Like, you know how like now, like yeah. Now is back there. I'm not saying that she's
is it back there?
No, I think she got work done.
I'm saying in this current climate. Oh. You're not listening. I'm saying in this current climate, like she wouldn't even.
Yeah, you'd never look at her.
You wouldn't look at her. Like growing up, yeah, Beyonce's curvilicious. She's yeah, this. Yeah. She's like, everyone used to go mad for her body.
Look
yeah
at her pictures.
But she's quite small.
Yeah, look at pictures. She
like, she's thick.
I'm confused. Like.
No, I'll show you pictures.
No, hold on.
Small, okay, small like who? Put
small in the sense of, I feel like one.
I think Jennifer Lopez had a bigger bum than her.
No, okay, cool. Here's something I need to say. The world told us a dream, yeah? J-Lo hasn't got a fat ass.
Nope.
She never has had a fat ass. She just had a nice shaped little petite ass.
Yeah, but at that time, there was a fat ass.
Nah. There
was no, but at that time in the 90s. Ghana. No, at Nigeria. That time in the 90s, that was a fat ass.
Yeah, to celeb in the celeb world. Yeah.
No, to but, every, because that was the image that was poured out.
No, the way it is, pre J-Lo, it's all about breasts.
Yeah.
Page 3, all of that. She was the first celebrity ass, and she made asses kind of famous, but
look,
in hindsight now,
that's Beyonce. That was Destiny's Child, Beyonce. That everyone was guessing is yeah, curvy. She's not that curvy. She wasn't that curvy.
I think she does better. Yeah, I like it here.
That literally, I was talking to my friend. I was like, "That's the biggest myth we ever sold." No, but Beyonce was hella thick.
I don't think I don't think we all sold that though.
No, I think we.
There was a whole song called "Bootylicious."
Yeah, but
that was based
on
her.
Yeah, but where was the booty in the video? I thought they were just using it as a term just to describe everyone, not themselves.
It was a term, but they coined it for her.
Because
I remember you've got
no,
that.
But listen, I'm a connoisseur of these things. So even when I saw it, I thought, where's the booty? That's what I always thought when I saw a booty video. I didn't think, yeah
Beyonce, she's small.
No, but I never thought Beyonce had fat ass.
No, but I'm saying, but that's what we were sold.
Yeah.
I didn't get sold that. I never thought Beyonce was curvaceous or buff or whatever. She's pretty. I've always liked Lauren London, to be fair. I mean, Lauren Luckett. Latoya Luckett, sorry. I thought she was the best in this
situation. Latoya Luckett was cute.
So yeah, Beyonce, Rihanna, Halle Berry. Who else on the overrated list?
I'm going to say Meg Thee Stallion. I'm going to be honest with you.
No way.
I think she's highly overrated.
Yeah,
I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, she's there.
Yeah.
Do you want,
even
body-wise,
I think
she has sex appeal. She got mad sex appeal, but she's overrated.
Do you want to know why?
She's
because
got skills, though.
Do you want to know why?
I even watch her moves and my mouth drop.
Oh, yeah. Her twerking,
her twerking is, listen.
And you know what? Some videos, her ass looks fat and others it doesn't.
Angles,
I'm confused, bro.
No, she doesn't have a big bump. It's just angles.
I tell you what, yeah, she's, I don't think she's overrated purely for the fact that she, even though she wears like a ton of makeup and whatnot, yeah, she's very like,
she looks like Moneybag Yo in the face.
Yeah.
She does
look a bit manly at times. I just hate her hair. No, the hair's not the problem. You know these fucking Primark shorts she loves to wear with a fucking crop top that looks like
she can't dress for shit. She can't dress for shit, we know that.
Like, it's so annoying that she wear that material. You know that material like when we used to buy like French knickers, the French boxers from Primark. But she loves doing
that. Well, the lace thing.
No, it's not even lace, it's like a cotton.
Okay.
I'll show you. All right, so
Meg, Rihanna, Halle Berry,
I'm
Beyonce.
I'm not going to sit and let you say Meg and Halle Berry is overrated.
No, because they are. Because they are.
Take one of them out.
Because they are.
Meg no, is highly overrated.
But wait, so why are you...
No, Halle Berry is overrated. Highly. To me, anyway. And I'm sure there's guys that agree with me. All right, who's taking the fifth spot?
Like these shorts, Gina. What the fuck is that?
The fifth spot, man.
Oh,
in this 2019.
Let me see.
When Fashion Nova's providing
she can't
clothes.
Dress, though.
She can't dress. That?
Definitely can't.
She can't dress. Like, but I don't think, I don't, to be honest, I'm not a fashion guru, but I don't think.
You
most,
don't have to be a fashion guru.
But
to
most,
it.
But, oh, but most, yeah. Most Americans.
Oh,
yeah.
Americans. When I went to New Orleans, we had a competition to see how many people would wear boots.
Yeah.
And this is like 42 degree weather, and they're saying 42 feels like 48. These bitches are wearing rodeo boots in the middle of fucking New Orleans. And I'm just like, what?
Jesus Christ, bro. What is
this? Let me see.
Armor of God.
No, it's not about Jesus Christ. We're talking about. There's a girl that I know.
Let me see, please.
It's going to be nothing to you because you don't know her. He understands what I'm showing him. Exactly.
Is this all the same person?
Yeah.
How can he say armor of God?
Well, you haven't seen that video before.
No.
Oh my days, juice. Let me
like
send it to you.
What is that?
All right, so who's taking the fifth spot of Overrated?
Fifth spot of Overrated.
She's buffed though.
Fifth spot Overrated. Do you know, I don't agree with Rihanna on that list though.
Same.
Is Rihanna on the list? I don't agree with Rihanna.
We're being Overrated.
No, I don't agree with no.
I feel her.
No, I
feel
like
she deserves all the accolades.
So Halle Berry.
Right.
So Halle Berry, Beyonce.
Yeah.
Stop saying Halle Berry's name,
yeah.
Man.
I don't really get why Meg's on there though.
Because I think
same. You all just said it. Now you want to take her off.
I wouldn't have put her on there.
Okay, cool.
I'm voting for Meg Thee Stallion. I don't think she's that great. Are you voting for Meg Thee Stallion?
Yes.
You must be because you put her on there.
Yes. Yeah. So two for not, two on. Brent, is Meg Thee Stallion overrated?
He doesn't even know, bro.
Does he know who she is?
Final vote.
Oh, sorry.
There you go.
Yes!
She's on the list.
Oh, all right, Brent, who else do you think is overrated?
Well, hold on, Brent, is Halle Berry overrated?
No, but she's overrated.
Okay.
Halle Berry, we've agreed.
Is Beyonce overrated?
I think she is.
See, it's a long while.
All right, Brent, who else?
Is Rihanna overrated?
Nah.
Your Caribbean sister?
That's your cousin, bro. But who else? Okay, who do you think is overrated in the industry?
The public just go crazy over, but not really that nice.
Oh, Gina Iko.
I think. Oh, do you know?
I don't think she's even that pumped up. Nice. I don't think she gets a lot of accolades.
Wedge, you don't feel it.
I do not feel it. I think she's highly overrated.
Oh yeah. Same.
You scared to say them?
No. Yeah, I think Steph London's highly overrated.
Oh, I thought that's what it was.
Who do you think it was?
I
thought it was Paigey.
I don't know.
What?
For Wales, I'm sitting here.
Yeah. That's a Paigey cakey, though.
I think she's.
Is Steph London overrated?
I think she's overrated.
Is she even rated that high?
I was going to say, I don't think people.
Even the ratings that she gets.
I don't think people put her on a pedestal that much.
They don't, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't think she's put her on the pedestal to be overrated.
I don't think she's overrated.
Yeah, I think she's overrated.
Wait, who else then? I think that's a good list that we have.
So, Meg, Halle, Rihanna, Beyonce.
No,
Rihanna's not on the list.
Oh, sorry, Rihanna. So, Meg, Beyonce, and Halle Berry.
Who else is really on the pedestal then? Because there's some people that I'm like, I understand that. Ashanti, I understand.
Your friend's doing their hair like you though these days.
Real, innit?
I do it better.
You do it better. Yeah. There's one picture where she looks very wee higgy, but.
The one that you sent to the group, and you were like, this is the first picture I don't like of her.
Yeah. Her hair looks fine because I saw pictures of her, she looks buff. But that picture in particular,
it was
a bit weird.
People said she looked like Don Cheadle.
Yeah. I saw that one. I died. Like I said, she's like a war machine, you know. No respect. I can't think of anyone else. Is Nicki Minaj overrated?
Sorry. I don't think she's that highly rated these days,
anyway. Isn't she? What's the video you sent me?
Yeah, play it. She wants to know why I kept on saying it.
Jesus Christ! Put on!
Jesus Christ.
We love you, God.
Mom, ain't that like a essay type guy?
Yeah. I love how you call him the essay type guy. A Latino.
Oh, sorry. What up, homes?
No, listen. That
little joker, homie.
These videos, yeah. When I tell you, they
kill me. Jesus Christ.
Armor of God.
Jesus Christ. Put on.
No, it's because he said put on the armor of God.
Is he being serious though?
Which is what's killing
me. He's being serious.
Oh my God. Alright, cool. Okay, cool.
That's a good topic.
Who's the male overrated list? The guys there.
Do you know, that's a bit strange because I don't feel like women like all jump to the same person.
Yes, they do. They jump to AJ. I'm not saying he's overrated.
See, the thing about AJ is I can understand that objectively he's handsome, but I am not like in love with AJ.
Okay. No, Gina, who's... So we've done the girl list. Who's the male list? The overrated list.
Did she say AJ?
No. I said that I understand objectively that AJ is very handsome, but I am not in love with AJ like that.
I'm in love with him, bro.
All right, so who's on the Overrated list?
I'm trying to think. Who do people...
Ovi. I'm joking.
What? Are you mad?
I'm joking, man.
No, Ovi's... He's
Ovi's fantastic.
Nah, man, he's
no, who do... Come on, Crystal. Who do people gas?
Yeah, that's this not, one kind of thing.
That's like...
Yeah.
Cheers.
I don't know. Who do women guess?
To be fair, women always guess the same two or three guys. So
what,
it's like
Idris.
Idris is universally guessed.
It's not a video of him on a skateboard.
That's like, Zaddy.
The same guy.
Idris.
Joshua.
Michael B.
Ooh.
Michael B's fantastic.
Yeah, he is.
He's flipping handsome, seriously.
Right, I respect
him. Sure. No, he is. Calm down, son. No, I appreciate it, but that was a bit too much for him.
No, okay, is it too late for another homer?
Eager man.
No, too much energy. He's flipping handsome, isn't he?
What about, I'm trying to think in the UK, like who people gas, yeah?
The girls in the UK, they gas.
Don't they gas
Fredo a little bit. Yeah,
Fredo's not nice.
I've seen girls gas Tion Wayne, I've seen them gas Fredo.
Tion Wayne's overrated.
None of them.
I think who else the girls gas? Scorcher.
Oh, no, Scorcher's a good one.
Skepta,
but now he's looking a bit
with the plats.
With the Jamaican.
It's so funny, yeah, because Jesse always sends me his snaps. He's like, this is your man's, yeah. And I was like to him, I don't like him anymore. He goes, we thank God.
Do you know who I do feel though? Young Bean.
No, I don't.
No, I know, but he has like a sex appeal that I'm just like, oh.
Really?
Yeah.
Where?
I don't know.
What is his sex appeal?
He just has like this bad boy, but I like bad boys.
Bad boy? Young Bane and bad boy don't go together.
No, he has a bad boy look. Doesn't mean that he's a bad boy, but he has a bad boy look.
Does he?
Yeah. Young Bane definitely has.
I don't see how he has a bad boy.
I don't know, because my taste is a bit different, isn't it? My taste is.
It's a bit what? It's a bit tall.
Yeah, it's a bit tall.
A bit basketball mind, would you say?
It is.
It's basketball mind.
That is my taste.
Who wants to go film? That's about it, you know?
Yeah, AJ, I think. Yeah, AJ is handsome.
Yeah, you know, you know, the thing is, well, I'm asking you, who's over, well, Tion Wayne, you said overrated.
Yeah,
Tion
Wayne, Fredo, definitely overrated. Who else?
There isn't a wide variety of guys.
Yeah, because I think there is, women's taste is a bit wider.
But there is about the UK. UK lacks a lot of heartthrobs.
Yeah, definitely.
Whereas Americans have heartthrobs in abundance.
Because you got like what you got, like the Donny Savages in America.
Here you've got Nathan.
Who
the fuck is Nathan?
Isn't he in prison?
Yeah,
he is. No, he's not in prison now.
He bangs fraud.
Yeah. He's not in prison though. I saw him. In New Cross, bruv.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
What?
After hours, bruv.
Are you serious?
Oh, how recent was his case?
Like last year?
I don't know.
The year before?
No, they're not in prison. Even the year before, he's not in prison.
No, maybe
I saw him last year.
Maybe he already did this time.
I saw him last year. No, yeah, because I remember I asked Luke. I said, oh, wasn't he meant to be? I think he said, nah, he's out or whatever. Yeah, you got Michael Dapper. You got Murder Comedian, you got Big Nasty in the man. No,
but they're like good looking guys.
I'm joking. I'm banging.
No. You? No, like, I think, what's his name? Murder Comedian, I think, is a good looking guy.
Yeah, Mark is not.
He's not like a heartthrob, but I think
so. Yeah, but I'm saying.
He's a normal, good looking guy.
There aren't any heartthrobs in the UK.
No?
Yeah, that's true.
No, like, Ovi came from nowhere.
And that's why every girl is mad.
I'm dead. He's come from nowhere and sent every girl spinning.
No, but the thing is, there's girls out there who know Ovi.
No, I know.
Who've dated Ovi, who've seen Ovi out.
Yes,
there is.
He ain't never been to one DLT brunch.
Oh, no, my
man's
goodness.
Never been trending. Man's never been fucking nowhere.
Lux Sundays.
Lux, never. What
Summer
the fuck?
Of Love, Wagwan. And he's chiseling it. And he knows Chizzo.
Yeah.
I know you were here lipsing porn star India, bro.
Is she a porn star?
She's on Pornhub.
I don't know who that is.
The white girl, man.
But it's like, okay, for example, if he went on Love Island, there's bad girls who don't know who he is, so they're going to say the same thing.
No, but it's different.
And the ones that do know him will be like, oh, that's Dami. Yeah.
No, because Ovi's different.
Why?
Because Ovi's just different. Like,
oh, you're trying to say, oh. No, but I don't mean, I'm not talking about his looks. I'm just,
looks wise. I just mean him as a human being. No, but the look should have propelled him.
What, in real life?
Yeah.
What I heard though was that he had about 5k followers before Love Island. Now he's got like a million.
He's got Bez.
Yeah, I saw whose page did I go on recently? And this just got bare followers. I think it was
993,000 right now.
There we go. I think from 5k to
shit. Maybe I should go on Love Island.
No, you should. Do you know they get paid 650 a day?
Do they?
I will do it.
What, a young contracting job?
Yeah, 650 a day.
That's get paid.
That's why Michael weren't trying to leave, bro.
I thought it wasn't paid.
No, they get paid apparently 650 a day, and then we calculate if you're there for the whole 12 weeks, you're getting 52 bags.
So what's the point of the prize money and all that shit then?
It's just to keep you there. Like, it's also to keep us feeling like there's something.
Something
that they're gonna win, but they get paid. That's why Michael's like, I'm here for the Love Island experience. He knows I'm not trying.
He knows about Love Island. The girls are whack.
The girls are higgy.
And the girls aren't my type. So I'm going to go in there. I'm going to go in there and do an Ovi and just be there for the holiday.
Ovi is living his best
and
life.
And be there because I know as I'm in here, I'm building the brand. The Boohoo deal is coming because this is Boohoo and ASOS. They just jump on anybody.
Yeah.
But
no, not ASOS. It's Pretty Little Things.
Yeah, Pretty Little Thing. No, but
so Boohoo. How comes there's two seasons of...
There's a US one.
No, but they're saying that now we're going to get two a year, isn't it? Or no, because
the South African one as well.
No, they announced that they're going to do a winter one here.
Really?
Yeah, it came out. We're going to get
but
two
how are they going to do a winter one?
We're going to get two a year.
Is it not going to be in South Africa? Because this is
winter. Yeah, it might be in South Africa, but it's going to be UK.
We're getting two a year.
In South Africa.
Yeah, no, they might do it there,
so
but
not
I'm saying...
Spain, because obviously they need someone that's going to be hot during our winter.
Oh, I thought they were going to do a winter theme.
No. Because they still want us in, they still like, want them in bikinis.
Alaska and them things.
They still want to sell bikinis and shit.
Okay. No, but Boohoo, though, them guys are relentless, cuz. Fam, they have an ad with Gunner.
Do they?
Or somebody of that ilk. I've seen... I've seen Tiger.
With, is it Boohoo? Yes, Boohoo.
It's Boohoo.
And they've got Quavo.
Who's Quavo?
Quavo.
Oh my God! You made me sick.
Oh wait, that's not worse than Epitome. Get out of here, fam.
It's not
worse than Epitome. Don't try it.
I like Epitome. So you can't get
that
me.
That sounds like a girl.
I love it, bro.
The Epitome.
Is a, listen, I should coin that, bro.
I saw the picture.
Who's that?
Who's that?
Let me see, man.
Right, Ovi, calm down.
No, but you are just on your phone silent, bro.
You might need to add a no homo stuff.
Nah. Listen, bro.
There we go. You ain't got tats in it, so before you start coming.
Oh, is that what it is? Is the tats?
Yes.
No, the tats. Oh, it is. Oh, my God.
I like guys with tattoos.
I love tattoos.
If I ever... Why is Miss Banks liking... Miss Banks, move, bro. Wait.
Apparently she's on it. Apparently she's
on it. Oh, you know what I'm going to do? Right now, I'm going to go to my Instagram. I'm going to Ovi's page and I'm going to see which like girls that I know.
You know what killed me? When Jesse literally was like... Basically, it first came to our attention, yeah, who Ovi was, yeah. Then he was like, Gina, already? I said, fam, I clicked that follow quick. Right.
Ovi's page.
What
okay,
do
cool.
you mean?
Let's see. All right, Just Jean's there, first name, liked by.
Where down there?
I hate when I see girls I know in the comments of these guys. Relax! You're a normal person, bro. You're in the comments talking about... I'm livid. Hold on.
Kiss me, daddy.
Let me see. Who do I know? Rock. Okay, hold on. The funny thing about Instagram, it shows you who you follow first. Okay, cool. I'm not going to say her name. I know her.
Everybody's on there, bro.
This list is long.
Look, these are all the girls I'm following. Wait. All the girls I'm following. Look. Following. Shit is not stopping. Okay, stop there.
Yeah, because everybody's onto him, bro.
Hold on,
I mean, I don't follow him.
Hold on, is there anyone that's...
I just pre when I need to pre.
Dami, there as well.
Don't try.
Dami likes.
Dami's there, bro. Oh, Lady's there as well. That's my cousin. Liking the picture. That's funny, bro. Alright, so Ovi's not overrated. Ovi's the guy for you.
No, Ovi's fantastic. Ovi for the win, bro.
Can I get some sweets, please?
Which one would you like?
I'm trying to think who else.
Oh, where's my chocolate? That was here. Where? Did you eat?
Chocolate.
There was a little bit of chocolate.
No, you ate it, bro.
No, I didn't eat it again.
Oh, it's on the floor. You know the pink and white ones?
Pink and white?
Yeah.
Oh, why has it gone on my head? Squishies.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I eat better, but I never know the names. Thank you. All right. What else? What else is good, people? What else is good? This is a podcast.
I thought you were going to talk about brown skin girls, Gina.
Where don't come into.
Why are you on your phone so much today? What's going on there?
Basically,
she's getting at the docket.
Yeah, I'm just trying to update the docket. Calm down, bruv. I'm not talking to anyone.
Kermit.
So obviously that's my song of the week. Just putting it out there.
Brown skin girl.
Brown skin girl by Beyonce.
I haven't even listened to that album. I don't even like Lion King. Like
Beyonce
that.
And
it's not Lion King.
And just songs, huh? Cool. But anyway, what has annoyed me? Yeah.
So free agency, huh?
Are you dumb?
I'm joking.
Anyway, what has annoyed me is so they've released a song that's called Brown Skin Girl.
Yeah.
And when I heard the song, I got really emotional. I'm not gonna lie. Like I actually was like,
Gina, Papa put a post.
No, I did, because I got that. I legitimately had tears. Like, I wanted to cry. Oh. And I was like, why am I crying? You know, why do I feel so emotional? And it was because the song really was, like, resonating with me. And I was like, if I heard this song when I was... It's a very nice song, innit? And it's a song that I felt like my younger self needed to hear, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. And you know I'm always talking about colorism and whatnot. So I'm obviously going to be passionate about it.
Yep.
Anyway, this song's come out now, and literally most Black women that I know of who've heard the song have all felt the same, regardless of your complexion. We're all Black in it. The song is called Brown Skin Girl. Isn't that every black person is brown? We're just all different shades of brown. So the song isn't specific to a certain skin colour. This prick with some dead accent.
Well, I disagree. I think it is.
What?
Because she describes a certain type
I know,
of woman.
But then in the same breath though, the person singing the song in the beginning is her daughter. Her daughter's not dark skinned.
Yeah, she's trying to tell us girls love yourself.
Yeah, no, but I'm saying that the song isn't specifically, I don't think the song is specifically aimed at dark-skinned women.
I think it is.
I think it's aimed at Black women. Fair enough, she describes Lupita.
No, and she describes so dark that they can't throw shade. She
right,
can't say
but then
things.
there's different parts to the song. That's not the consistent theme throughout the whole song, in my opinion. It's not like the second verse. Do you get what I'm trying to say? And if that's the case, I'm seeing it as she's teaching her daughter about self-love, because her daughter is singing the song in the beginning and at the end. It's like, not like a nursery rhyme, but it's a song that she's taught her daughter. I didn't see it as her daughter's telling us to love ourselves. What's this six-year-old going to tell me? I see it as she's teaching her daughter that about self-love.
No, I agree.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? So that's why I don't think it's a song aimed specifically at dark-skinned women. And Beyonce's not dark-skinned either. So I'm not saying that she's not going to sing a song. Do you get what I mean? Like, I don't think that's the case. And if that was the case, I'm pretty sure the song would be called Dark Skin Girl. But anyway, I digress. There's obviously people that have come now, the light-skinned people who've got upset. And there's a woman who's made a light-skinned version of the song. And I'm like, this is what I mean about Black people. I don't understand. Just like the song and go. Now you've made it a whole thing. Oh, this is for my light-skinned sisters. And you've remixed the song talking about light skin. And now there's a whole debate about light skin versus dark skin. Again, fam. Like the song and move. Mm. The song is, the thing is, the song is called Brown Skin Girl. Like, they clearly did that for a reason, yeah? In terms of not it being ambiguous, but it covering a whole umbrella of people. We're all Black. We're all different shades of brown. So I don't understand why now there's this new debate about, this song is this and this song is that. It's like, fam, the song's beautiful, isn't it? Like, just let it live and keep it moving.
Can we play it?
I kind of disagree with you in the sense of, I think it is... Okay. I do think it is aimed mainly at that dark-skinned women. But in the same sentence, I don't think it's a song that Beyonce intended for only dark-skinned women to listen to and identify with.
Yeah.
I agree that it's supposed to be for all shades.
Yeah.
But I think because of her specific mentions of certain things and certain people, that she is trying to aim it more at dark-skinned women. But that doesn't mean that, I agree with you. This whole debate of, like, because then also I've seen like Asian women bring themselves under that. Oh, but I'm a brown skinned woman.
Yeah, they are.
It's like, no, it's not for you.
No, but this is the thing though. I'm not trying to tell an Asian person.
I don't think so.
That they can't identify with the song, because Asians are classed as brown skinned.
No, you can. Right? I just don't think the song was aimed for you. And so therefore I don't think you should be in this debate as to who the song is for. I think it's just if you identify as a brown skinned woman,
then
Asian,
the song is for you.
Then the song's for you.
Precisely. But so then you can't tell me that. So in the same breath, if I identify as a Black woman, you can't tell me that I can't identify with the song, because that's what you've just said.
No. I didn't say that. What I said is, I think the song and the song lyrics are aimed directly at dark-skinned women. But I don't think that Beyonce's intention was that all Black women couldn't identify to it. But I do think that the woman that she's describing is a dark-skinned woman.
Okay.
Now, does that mean that other shades of black women can't enjoy it? No, I don't think that at all. But does that mean that it's supposed to be inclusive for Asians and whatever? If you identify as a brown-skinned girl and you feel like you're discriminated, fine. You can also enjoy it. I'm not saying that people can't. But then the debates that people have been having is when light-skinned girls have been saying the song's about me. Not this woman. Not this woman that's made her own stupid remix. But there's been women on Instagram, on Twitter, like lighter shade women, like light skin or whatever. They've been saying, no, the song's about us.
But I don't see why that's a problem. The song's about brown-skinned women. So if you're brown, but that's the thing though, because if you're making a song only aimed at dark-skinned women, you're also encouraging the segregation.
I don't think she didn't say other women can identify with it. Right. But I'm saying the woman that she is celebrating and talking about is a dark-skinned woman.
Okay, cool.
So that's my point.
But the song, whether
other black women can identify, I'm not saying you can't. I think the problem is when there's certain shades of women saying, no, this song is for us. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah, but it's not taken away.
Speaking about a dark-skinned woman.
Yeah.
So I'm not saying that black women can't appreciate it. I think that was the aim of it, that we're all supposed to appreciate it. But the woman she's describing is a dark-skinned woman.
Can I just say though, I haven't been following this, but from what you guys are saying, part of the annoyance would be the fact that you've got people that are not black trying to obviously claim it for themselves as well.
Almost. I haven't seen that.
No, I don't have a problem with if you're like, let's say you're a Sri Lankan woman and you are darker shade, appreciating you. I don't think that's a problem. I think the problem is the conversations that I was seeing on Twitter where it's like light-skinned black women creating a narrative of, no, this song was for us. Exactly the same. So they're using, no, but it's called brown skin and you guys are dark skin. If she was talking about dark skin, do you get me? That's
what I mean, because I saw one or two tweets about people like posting pictures of brown skinned women, but none of these women were black, kind of thing. But it was just like, Beyonce says brown skinned girls, and then you guys hear this kind of thing. And then it was
like racially ambiguous person.
Yeah, like, but it's a bunch of like Asian women, pretty much. Asian and Asian women predominantly kind of thing. And then someone else did one where it's like, okay, Beyonce meant this kind of thing. They had a picture of like Lupita and then
isn't that the beauty of the song though? The fact that it's so,
that's what I took from
that's
it.
That's what I'm saying, fam. I don't get it. Like, for me, I like the fact, I like and this is me, the dark skin champion. Yeah. I like the fact that it's inclusive for everyone.
Yeah.
And it's not, yeah, she references dark skin women, sick, love it. I'm not taking away from that. But I also like the fact that the title of the song is brown skin. Every black person is brown. Mm. Like, we're not... Like, do you understand what I mean? Your complexion is brown.
Some of us are black.
Yeah.
I've seen black people.
Because I think that's the complexity that's come into this conversation. That because we have classified black people in certain things, right? So we have light skin.
So then isn't that the purpose of the song?
And then we have brown skin
to bring everyone together.
That's what I'm saying. The problem that we're now having is because we have light skin, which some people will say is mixed race or just a bit yellow. Then we have brown skin, which is in the middle of dark skin and mixed race. And then we have dark skin. So I think that's where it's causing the divide in people saying the song is for.
But the thing is, I also see it as the purpose of the song is to to eradicate all that and bring it together.
I agree with you, but that's why I posted that we just can't enjoy it.
That's why it's annoying, because it's like, fam, just enjoy the song and move. Like, I don't get it.
Yeah.
There's no reason to pick the song apart. Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
But anyway. Yeah, that was
I want to hear it, but if we play it now, I know that song's going to get taken down off YouTube.
It's going to be my song of the week though, so.
But I think I have a bigger problem. Play it anyway. I have a bigger problem with that album rather than that song.
What's the issue? Oh, are you one of those people that are livid? Because it's only West African eyes.
Yeah.
Is it only West African?
And two South Africans, yeah.
Okay.
And so, who are the South African eyes?
No, but my thing is,
Moonchild, Wiley, and Busisa.
Why is that?
Lady Smith, Black Mamba, bro.
Where are you from?
But then that's like people saying, oh, I'm angry because most of the artists were Nigerian.
No, not really. Because if you're saying the album is for Africa,
yeah,
it's a representation of Africa, represent Africa.
Okay, cool.
I don't have a problem if they put an album and said, we chose all the popular artists. Not a problem.
But not isn't that what she said, though? She said she wanted to pick. She said she went to pick the best artist from Africa.
Beyonce said that.
Yeah.
But there's other A&Rs and other people that worked on that who have now had interviews and said other things. So there was one person that was like, well, no, just East African artists just didn't bring the goods. And I'm just like...
but is that a bad thing, though?
Well, maybe that's the truth.
If they didn't bring the goods, then what's the problem?
No. Because even if that is the truth,
yeah,
if you wanted to represent,
yeah,
go and find the best in East Africa. Because
so what if there wasn't one?
You can't say that there isn't.
No, I'm asking.
No, but that is the problem. And that is the problem that East Africans are saying. That's bullshit. Because when West African artists wanted to go get exposure in the East, who did they collaborate with?
They collaborate
with Diamond Platinums, with Salty Soul, with certain artists in the East. So if you're going to say you're going to represent Africa, then represent Africa. I don't have a problem with saying that this album was just, I picked the popping people.
We're just never going to win, you know? Mm.
No. And I disagree with that. No, and the reason why I disagree with that is because I feel like we always do this when there's constructive criticism. This is the product that you gave me. Mm. This is the product that you said you're going to produce. You said you're going to produce an album that's representative of Africa, yeah, right? Africa's 54 different countries,
yeah,
different sounds,
so
different whatever.
Would you have been happy? What would you have been happy with?
If you said, I've just made an album with popping artists from Africa, don't say it represents Africa, because when a group of people say, I do not feel represented, you can't then turn around and say, well, we can't win. Yeah, because fair you didn't enough represent me.
It's true.
And I don't, do you get what I mean? I'm not mad at the product. I'm mad at the album. I think the album's sick. My problem is the messaging that people have now said so that we all rally. Oh, Africa, this is a win for Africa. But if people are saying they don't feel represented, you take that criticism and you take that feedback and you're like, okay, cool. Do you know, next time we'll make sure we do it.
So how do we not know that that's not happened though?
What? Because that's it. Because the interview, when they're saying, why didn't you have East Africans? And instead of saying that, you're like, oh, well, because East African people didn't bring the goods. And it's like, but there's artists there that are popping.
I don't know.
And it's a valid, as I said, I'm Congolese and I identify more as an East African and as South African, or a Southern or East African. So yeah,
you're
I would
in the
say
middle,
I
right?
Yeah, well, no, because Central African Republic's in the middle. We are technically classified as South. But if a whole group of people, if Kenyan people and the Lion King is based in Kenya and Tanzania are saying we don't feel represented, I think that's kind of just something that we can be like, okay, cool. We fumbled the bag this time. Next time, if we want to make an album for Africa, the continent, let's take this criticism to hand. That's it.
Fair enough.
I need context, but I'll get context later. Look, the thing is, I saw the album. And I'm like, oh yeah, but it's got an Afrobeat album, whatever, but I just haven't time to listen to it.
Yeah. And don't get twisted, I understand the business reason of having popping artists. I'm an A&R, I understand. But I also understand if you're going to A&R something and say, this is what I'm going to provide and give you, then do that.
Yeah.
And if people say they don't feel like, then take it on the chin and be like, okay, cool. But don't go to now insult a whole bunch of people by saying, well, your artist didn't really...
That's funny, dude.
I guess it's a get out clause, isn't it?
Yeah.
Of course it is. Like, they're not gonna sit there and admit they fumbled the bag. So they're gonna shift the blame.
But you know the music industry, isn't it? You're gonna put the most popular artist on the album.
Mm-hmm.
And as I said, I agree with that.
Yeah.
But then that's what I'm saying. Don't then say this is a win for Africa because you want all Africans to rally towards you to support it.
It still kind of is a win for Africa, though.
Because you're Congolese, isn't it? That's why.
No, but
I still think it doesn't mean that it's still not a win for Africa, though.
No, it's not a representation of Africa.
Okay, cool. I hear that. But it's still not...
But does it have to be...
It's not a win, though.
No, but you're arguing for South Africa. You're not arguing for all the other African countries.
No, I'm arguing for every single African country that didn't...
So we should include a country on a song from every single country in Africa?
No, I don't think, because Africa's split into regions, right? So you've got East Africa that has its own music scene,
yeah,
very distinct.
Yeah.
You have South Africa that has its own distinct music scene. You have West, so I'm not saying go get 54 songs.
Yeah.
I'm saying represent those regions.
But if the most popular artists are all from one place.
But this is what I'm saying to you. Then that's how you sell your album. Don't say that this is a representation of Africa, especially when it's based on a film based in East Africa.
Listen, why are we fighting? We're all African, baby.
That's what I said.
Nah, man. We're only African when someone wants someone to rally towards a cause. Otherwise, I'm Nigerian. I'm this. I'm that.
No. Listen, I don't think the divide that we see in public is all banner. It's not real. Like, okay, cool.
Africa, no, but that's like Nigerian, the same.
It's all banner. But we're really.
Said,
I think we're really united.
all majority of the artists on the album are Nigerian. There's only one Ghanaian artist. Haha, Ghana. It's because Nigerian jollof is better. It's like,
is this bad? Yeah, it's bad. It's not serious.
Yeah.
It's all just.
No, it's no. It's not serious to us, but it's serious to people on the continent. There are people dying in the name of tribe and land and country divides. There yeah. are.
Yeah, but that's not about the album, though.
No. I'm not saying that. But you're saying, when you're saying we're all Africans, I'm saying no. We're all Africans when someone wants us to rally towards something. But in reality, there's hella divide.
Yeah, of course. That's life. But I'm talking about here in London.
Then I got baddies in London.
I'm talking about our African community. I'm not talking about what's happening back home. Obviously, back home is a madness. I'm talking about what's happening in London, you know, in our African community we have here.
No, because some people still carry that.
What, here?
No, because you might have some of your parents. Wait, there are even some of my Ghanaian friends that be like, my mum said I can never marry a Nigerian.
I'm
saying I have some Ghanaian friends where my parents said they can, or my parents said I can never marry this tribe.
Yeah.
Even. So some people still carry that. I'm not saying, yeah, we are a bit.
Yeah, obviously people individually carry whatever from their past or whatever, but as a whole, man, we are one, you get me?
I believe that. I'm a Pan-Africanist, which is why I feel like if it was going to be represented, let's represent it properly.
Can we just have good things? Gina's like.
By the way, is there going to be a part two? I'm not watching it, but is there going to be a part two?
Well, like, the worst thing is, that I generally think part two is even better than part one, because...
Which one was part two again?
Simba's Pride.
Oh, yeah.
The song got lit, man.
He lives in me. Upgraded.
And what's it called?
The songs were fucking Deception upgraded. Disgrace.
That song.
He lives in Hela, Himalaya.
Hella,
he lives
the songs
in
are number two
Hela,
are lit.
No,
honestly,
I don't even remember part two.
Hemanaya.
How can part two be better than part one, though? This is impossible.
No, it's in the music from the soundtrack.
It's the spirit of life.
Keep going.
Calling.
Oh, oh, Eo. But the soundtrack.
Mamela. Oh, Eo.
All right.
What is going on here?
Hella.
I thought you were going to do that.
You know what I'm talking about.
Ah, that's
my shit. And
Deception.
That's my favourite song. Disgrace.
Yeah. That's with Simba and the girl in it.
Yeah.
And
Nala.
No, that's what I remember.
It's about Simba, Nala, and Kovu.
But to be fair, I've been hearing reviews that Lion King's crap, though.
Yeah, lots of people have been saying Lion King's crap.
You know what it is? I've heard that it's exactly the same as the cartoon, but the cartoon obviously makes it better
it's not a different story, though.
No, but I mean, I can't really screen for screen. Like, whereas Jungle Book ain't like that. Yeah. Like, with the Jungle Book.
I didn't watch the Jungle Book. Would you recommend it?
And they're saying that Beyonce is not good.
Yeah, everybody.
But Beyonce's voice is flat anyway.
You know what the problem is?
Told you, she's overrated.
But this is the thing, yeah. You know, as an actor.
No, singing, she's fantastic.
For example, Jamie Foxx, yeah.
Oh, he's fantastic.
I know I'm being extreme and the comparison isn't.
What, is Jamie Foxx liking?
No, I'm saying, as an actor, like, whatever role you play, you kind of switch up your accent. That's what you're really meant to do, innit? But fam, this is in Africa. Man's got a Texas accent in Africa. Like, it's just, and it sounds too much like.
And for someone who can sing so well, she doesn't know how to manipulate her voice.
But she has a flat speaking voice anyway. Yeah, she doesn't have much expression when she's talking. So now, when you just got a script,
that's why Beyonce's
boring
in bed.
It.
I'm telling you.
How do you know that?
Right. Listen to the voice.
Nah, do you know? Because you know Beyonce comes in her braggadocious.
You know, innit?
I feel like she's lit.
No, Beyonce and Jay-Z don't like they have lit sex.
Yeah, they talk like they're having lit sex.
They don't like they have it, though.
Nah, because
you never know, man. They might be.
Have you seen Jay's hair?
Yeah.
It's not the hair of a guy who has lit sex.
What is the hair of a guy that has lit sex?
Like a fade, something.
You're a dickhead. You said a fade.
You've seen his hair?
Why must you have a fade to have lit sex?
Because the fade is the haircut of champions.
So when does the haircut kick in, though? When you first had the lit sex?
From birth, baby.
Oh, okay.
This is in you, you get me? The haircut just emphasizes the power, the epitome. Listen, I had to find a definition of epitome. Because
epitome.
No, epitome is a different word. Epitome is the word, it's a new word. I had to find a definition of epitome. Like, it should mean hard, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, epitome.
The epitome sounds like a girlfriend.
The what?
I've used it in a sentence.
What, epitome? Actually.
Epitome. It's not a real word.
It's not a real word.
It's not a real word.
It's what I made up
by trying to read epitome.
You still can't even say it.
You still struggled.
No, but that's like
reciprocity.
No, I can say really it. I can say epitome. I just started.
I really struggle with reciprocity.
Rep what?
Reciprocity.
Do you know what I struggle with?
Math.
Magnificent. No.
Magnificent.
Magnificent. No.
Maleficent.
Wow.
Mag, hold on. Get my chi ready. Magnificent.
Hey. Magnificent.
Wow.
Magnificent.
Wait, wait, one person say it.
Magnificent.
Magnificent.
Yeah.
I always struggle. I don't know why I always struggle to say it.
You made up some.
Magnificent. Say again.
Mag.
Yeah.
Nif.
Yeah.
E.
Magni. E.
Nah, sorry.
Magnificent.
Just don't use it. Yeah.
Magnificent.
Yes.
Magnificent.
Uh-huh.
Magnificent.
Boy George
That's
has got
magnificent.
It.
Magnificent. Yes. No, for some reason, I always struggle to say it. I don't know why.
Do you know what? You, the way you're saying it, you sound like Chris Eubank. You know? Magnificent.
Oh, listen to what you're going to say.
Stupendous confectionery.
Do you know what? I've got a story about this guy, though.
Would you like a sweetie?
do you know what? Yeah? People think that's an act, yeah?
No, that's how it is.
No, that's genuine. And I remember, yeah, my mum took all of us out, yeah? Me and my brother. And my sister, which took us all out to West End, yeah? No word of a lie, I must have been about 8 or 9. Guess who I see, like, on the corner in West End, just standing there with
giving out sweeties?
No, just standing there on his corner in his like, you know those boots he likes to wear? Yeah, and like
the
that, and yeah, and like those, I don't know, what you call it? Those, like, barbell jackets or whatever.
Yeah, no, him. Yeah. Big man, I saw him driving a tractor in West End.
Yeah, listen.
Wearing his blazer or whatever.
So imagine, yeah, he's just standing there in the street, yeah? And then my brother recognized him because, oh, that's Chris Eubank. Imagine this guy reaches into his folder, yeah? He's got pictures of himself already signed to hand them out. I swear to God.
Are you joking?
I swear to God. So I still have, do you know what, yeah?
Seriously?
Yeah, I found, when I was moving house.
You little boy.
Listen, when I was moving house.
Would you like a sweetie?
When I was moving house, yeah, I found my autograph picture of him. And you know, he was doing that, what do you call it, that Nescafe promotion at the time.
I don't remember
when
that.
When they're selling, I'll show it to you guys. But literally, it was him, yeah, drinking, like, holding a coffee mug. Yeah, a red coffee mug. And like, he literally signed. He had, in his phone, he must have, I don't know, hundreds of them in there. He was just ready to give them out if someone spotted him. That's just how he is.
Chris Eubank is funny, because I saw him in West End. He was driving a tractor on the roads, but dressed up in his normal outfit. I'm thinking, he's driving a tractor. Like, is he allowed? Is this a road-ready vehicle? What's going on here? But that's what Chris Eubank,
isn't it? You know what? That is life, you know?
And even his son, because I never heard his son speaking to recently. Yeah. His son kind of sounds like him a little bit.
You know, he's got another son. You know, he's got another son. Yeah. He's got another son, yeah, like out of that he doesn't really actually claim, yeah. He's a boxer as well. When I used to go to Yorkie's boxing gym in.
Wait, you mean.
I've forgotten his name. But he used
to. Moved to Dubai.
Yeah, I don't know if he moved to Dubai.
I used to follow him. What's his name? The Alkaline guy.
2015, 2016 really? Times.
Alkaline
yeah.
guy.
There's two of them, but they.
One of them he had with a black lady, innit?
No, he's
must have black
well,
lady.
He's like a bit darker. No, he's definitely
one of them here with a black lady.
No, this one's fully black. I used to go to the same boxing gym as him, in Tooting.
Let me show you the guy I'm talking about.
I'm like 90% certain.
Tremendous confectionery. That man's too funny. Oh, someone sent me something I want to use for a soundbite. What was
he
it?
He literally had his first fight probably in 2016 or 2017.
I know who you're talking about, and I'm annoyed because I used to follow him. And I did an event where we both spoke, and I'm annoyed because his name's proper come out of my head. What is his name? And he's friends with Shaka.
Hey, Bars.
Yeah.
Oh. No, Chris Eubank is a character, but I think him and his son are doing the. Was it the Google Box? Whatever. Yeah. I haven't watched the full episode yet, but
Google
that's.
Box.
Google you mean Box.
Seb,
Google
right?
Box. Oh, Google Box.
No, it's not Seb.
Oh, it's Google.
Seb, it's someone else.
Oh, so it's Google. Not Seb.
No,
oh.
It's someone else.
So that's where the stupendous confession came from. Would you like a sweetie? It's a smartie.
Yeah, he's 22.
Stupendous confectionery.
He's still young. He literally just had his first fight, like in 2016, I think.
And what, you don't claim him?
You don't claim him, from what I know anyway.
Oh, no.
I swear, didn't want to have a fight there, didn't it?
I think so.
What was the boxing fight that happened this weekend?
Yeah, didn't want.
Oh, okay.
And who was he fighting?
I know no one paid attention to it, bro.
I think they only paid attention to Dylan White when he has a fight against.
Who did he fight against? Did he
win? Wow, that came out of nowhere. I think he did win, yeah. I'm not sure who fought though. You three are just all on your phone today, bruv. I don't understand what is going on.
I'm trying to find
the
picture.
Trying to
the docket, innit, no?
No, you ain't looking at the docket, bruv. You're doing work emails.
I'm not.
You're texting back the thing that you're trying to. Oh! Is it?
He's trying to line it up.
No, I said to God, I'm not.
He's trying to line it up.
And Gina's just. I don't know what Gina's doing.
She's but updating the docket.
That's him. That's him there. This is him here. That's him.
What, the white guy?
No.
He looks like some American guy.
He looks. Do you know what he looks like? He looks like
Oh yeah.
A Boogie with a hoodie.
This guy.
Who?
Have you never seen this guy?
Never.
I see him on Insta a lot.
Ed Sheeran.
Yeah. I see him a lot.
Never ever seen him before.
What's Ed Sheeran's album saying? Anyone listen to it?
I haven't heard it properly.
I've only listened to a little bit of it.
Swag?
I need to take it.
I think it's all right, I guess, but it didn't like move me or like...
Is it like a cultural appropriation thing? Embarrassment thing?
Is it? But it's a collaboration album.
Yeah, no, he's done bare parts. This is like part six.
Part six?
Yeah.
Of the same album?
No, part six of his collaboration series.
I have never ever listened to an Ed Sheeran album before in my life.
I've never listened to him. Like,
I think I listened to his like first ever collaboration series.
What was that?
Time ago, before he was signed.
Really?
Yeah, when he was still doing his, you know.
Sleeping on people's couches.
Fam. Yes. Sleeping on people's couches has led him to...
That's what I'm saying, fam. Doesn't know, but that was the time.
Yeah, yeah.
Because even he says it.
Yeah, he slept on Jamie Foxx's couch.
Yeah. That's even a story.
Jamie Foxx?
Yeah.
Back, you know.
How I think he went to LA or wherever, he was doing his guitar thing. You know, he just plays the guitar in public and Jamie Foxx saw him. He says he's got a gig, but he's got nowhere to stay. Jamie Foxx took him to his house.
Yeah, this guy hustled. Now he's the most streamed artist of all time.
Family's rich, you know.
Come on. And he still just has like shaggy hair, wears ugly jumpers.
Fam, never changed.
This is it.
That's the way
Shape of You have been streamed 4 billion times.
You what?
Still a tune. That's a tune though.
4 billion.
Probably one of his like...
Well, is that the highest streaming song of all time? Seriously?
Yeah.
Well, even higher than Lil X.
Yeah.
Lil Nas X.
I don't know why people... That song's not even that highly streamed.
It's not even that good of a song.
People have really hyped it up. He's only got like 500.
I know it's not as big as that, but I'm just saying, I'm just using the comparison. But it's...
No, but because people have said...
It's been on the billboard for 12 weeks.
Yeah, but people have said, oh, it's set to be the...
I've never listened to that song like...
Have you?
Full. Like, I've heard it. I've heard like the chorus and things like that, but I've never actually sat down and said, let me listen to the song.
No, it was it's been number one on Billboard for 12 weeks.
That but people would say, oh, it's set to be like the biggest song. I'm like, no, like Shape of You is. With 4 billion streams.
But is it bigger than We Belong to... Mariah Carey.
Yeah, basically. I said if it's another week, it'll beat hers, isn't it? Or something like
that. Yeah.
Yeah, on the charts, but not in terms of streaming. And
yeah, because streaming wasn't even big back then.
No.
But people are talking about it's set to be the highest stream. I'm like, no.
What song of all time?
Yeah. I'm like, no, it's not. It's nowhere near.
Okay, so Ed Sheeran has the crown.
Ed Sheeran and then Drake.
What Drake song?
God's Plan.
What?
Really?
Yeah. God's Plan.
Not even Nice for Wayne.
God's Plan.
God's Plan's got 2.6 billion.
I thought it was
Uchiwali,
but that's just me.
Uchiwali.
I
hope so.
That's just on Spotify. So double it for Apple Music and then whatever for Tidal.
Hold on, Spotify shows you this shit. God damn, I have to get Spotify because I love numbers and stuff like this.
Yeah, I need it for work, innit?
Nice for What? This is your only people who are like...
No, that's normal for
us.
But we need it for work because I need to look at...
What's Don't Stop?
This a rolling, not a stopwatch. This will never stop.
Who's that?
Drake.
This is Drake's page.
That's Drake's page, sorry. Yeah.
That's the video that had Michael Dasher in it, innit?
Yeah. Hold on, Drake's got a song called Don't Stop on the video.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't know that name.
Play it for me.
I just flipped the switch. Flip.
Oh, okay. It's this. Do you know what? I didn't take in
Non-stop.
I didn't take in Scorpion that much.
Oh, well.
I can't lie.
What song was that?
This a rolling, not a stop.
No, I've heard it, but I never realized it was a big song for him.
I didn't think
I never think that. But to be frank, Drake streams like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
So whether it's not a big song to us, he will stream.
So a song that was just on the album cut.
Honestly, radio played it all the time. Yeah. That's why I know the song.
In fact, all of Drake's album cuts can be singles.
Yeah, no. I think when he releases his albums, all the albums are on the charts.
Yeah.
Basically.
Because then what else? Who else is highly streamed?
Oh, is there? Non-stop Drake. It's on Scorpion.
Yeah.
I think I always skip that song, you know?
I think I haven't even listened to
Uptown
to
Funk
side
is also
of
a
it.
Big song.
Who?
Uptown
Who's
Funk,
that?
Mark
Who's
Ronson.
That?
What song's that again?
Well,
That's
Bruno Mars, no? It's not Bruno Mars.
Oh, featuring Bruno Mars.
But that is a tune, though.
Don't believe
Bruno Mars. That's Bruno Mars in general,
over 2
though,
billion
man.
Times.
To what?
Over 2 billion.
2 billion.
Wait, is that Mark Morrison?
Maybe even. Yes.
Hold on, is this an all time list?
Where have I been?
Yeah, in terms of highest stream songs.
Or ever on Spotify?
Yeah. No, ever.
No, but those are only Spotify numbers.
Yeah, so then normally what we do is. To work at Apple Music for urban, you kind of double it. Because that's the kind of...
That's a rough estimate though, bruv.
No, but that's the demographic. Yeah. So half the people are normally on Spotify or Apple.
Okay.
Tidal has less of a
small
share.
Yeah.
So when you're trying to work out, you just kind of double.
Oh, okay.
To figure out...
So hold on, what's the top 10 of all time?
Ed Sheeran.
Have you got that?
I can.
Yeah, get that up, please. Interesting still. I never knew that, Drake. Okay, non-stop. That's interesting still. But I'm still surprised at God's Plan, though. I didn't think that would be up there in Drake's highest stream songs.
Yeah. I thought it isn't. You Love Me. What's
no,
it called?
No, that was just his popular
song. Oh, shit.
Oh, oh.
That's what's popular
especially
now.
Especially because they had the whole bloody challenge. Yeah.
Oh, In My Feelings. Kiki.
No, In My Feelings is like...
Are you riding?
Oh, do you know, the problem is that you that charts normally do it by like countries. So the UK has its own.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. I thought they had like a worldwide combined.
Yeah, I'm trying to find it.
Too bad.
I'm gonna get these ones.
Kissing in the rain,
All right, let's do song of the week.
So based on Spotify,
yeah.
But this is, I think, last year. So based on last year,
yeah.
Hasn't all.
Yeah.
Shape of You.
Yeah.
One Dance.
Yeah.
Rockstar by Post Malone.
See, One Dance makes more sense to me than God's Plan.
But this was, remember this.
Not because I like the song, I just know that was more popular.
This came out after God's Plan.
Okay.
Sorry, before God's Plan.
Yes.
Closer, The Chainsmokers featuring Hasley.
No.
Thinking Out Loud.
Thinking
God's Plan was six, but obviously God's Plan's gone up now.
Yeah.
Havana by Camila Cabello.
No, Havana. It's a tune.
Okay, okay. I heard it.
Lean on.
As in lean on me.
Somebody to lean on.
Major Lazer.
Yeah, Major Lazer.
Okay. Do You Recall?
And DJ Snake.
Not Long Ago.
Featuring Emma.
I don't listen to much music.
Despacito.
Yes, that's what I'm thinking.
My cross genre knowledge is not great.
You need to up it if you're going to come to us. And then Love Yourself by Justin Bieber.
Oh,
I thought Justin Bieber would have more up there.
Oh yeah, I heard that. The funny thing is, do you know why I hear all these great songs like what you named like at the gym?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't obviously listen to them in my personal time. All right, quickly, we got an announcement to make.
Sunday, the 15th of September, we present to you Meet Us After Seven and Friends. Woo!
Yes.
I was struggling. I was doing it on purpose.
Okay, we got a new live show, guys. As she said, September the 15th, it's Meet Us After Seven with Friends. Who are the friends, you ask? Well, do
tell.
Brianna
of Toph.
It definitely will be.
So, the friends are... Should we announce the friends or just leave us a surprise?
Leave us a surprise. But your faves.
No, but the friends. The friends have to be the friends of the appeal, though.
True.
They're the epitome.
The epitome.
They are, it's true.
So the first friend we got is Julie Adenuga.
Watch her and you go back to back about this lie or so-called truth.
No, trust me. Listen.
Oh, it's still gonna be going on in September, bro.
Yeah, you never know.
Nah, it's over. All right, next guest, Gina.
Who's the next guest?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought Gina was in this.
No,
oh, yeah. Your fave, Mr. Beatboxer himself, Jesse, aka...
No, you have to announce them as a pair, don't...
Oh, okay, your favourite duo, Jesse and Gloria!
And then, next one. Man, I say...
Show me...
How you get down. Man, I say, swear down. Gracious K! Then we've got a few anonymous guests that we're not going to announce until later on. But yeah, so live show, September the 15th, 2019. This time it's going to be back at Sync. So it's not in Camden no more. It's at Sync.
Which
one is
Sync? In Shoreditch.
Uh-huh.
Where we had our first two live shows. That's what it's going to be. And you know what it was? Based off of the feedback from the last two live shows, people were like, you know what? Last show was live, but I want to hear you lot talk more. So this one's going to be more of us talking.
Less games, less all that extra stuff.
Yeah, more talking, more discussion, more crowd involvement. So less of the free action, less of me dancing around, less of Gina and Crystal doing a grime set. No, the last time show was sick. Don't get twisted, but people said, oh, I want to hear you lot talk more, boom, boom, boom. So this is going to be more of a discussion, debate type of live show, but it's going to be sick regardless. There'll be other things as well happening as well. So yeah, tickets are out right now from shoppers.com. Don't know. But yeah, back at Sync in Old Street. All the details are below in the description. And yeah, man, we there.
We live and we move.
All right, cool. Let's do the songs of the week.
Yep, yep.
It's over there, isn't it?
Nice, yeah.
Right there.
Who's gonna go first?
Are you already plugged into it?
No.
What's this?
It's between your legs.
Who wants to go first? That means I'm about to play some Freddie Gibbs and Madlib, innit?
No, but you know, I'm actually looking for something to play.
Don't lie, big man.
No, I'm saving that for tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
No, all right, I'll go first. You lot are darling.
I know what I wanted to play.
All right, I don't need this.
She already said. She...
I don't need it.
Oh, how come? Oh, you're on Bluetooth.
I'm Bluetooth. All right, so I'm going to play a song. Ooh, actually, it's tough, actually. Should I play something from Lost Tapes 2? Or should I play Class of Deja? I'm going to Castle Deja, I'm sorry.
Both will get ripped down if you tipulate for too long.
What, Castle Deja?
Lost Tapes 2.
How long is
it? No, remember, Brent removes this from the YouTube.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, Song of the
Week. Oh, and it don't get flagged up in...
on the pod, no.
Oh, that's all right.
Yeah, so Song of the Week doesn't go on YouTube, in case people didn't realise that. All right, so this is Kano's new single off his new album.
Oh, by the way, is anyone going to the concert? Tickets come out tomorrow, innit? Just saying.
Kano concert.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
When is it?
September the 7th.
Call me.
He's not, so.
You still can sort in it. All right. So this song here, to me, is a baddest, bruv. Ucker's baddest. Big man, don't feed the baddest pasta, yeah?
Okay, Fredo.
I can say Ucker's baddest.
By the way, do you guys know the words? I'm pretty sure I know all the words now. Who wants to go back to back?
This guy wants to go back.
I haven't heard the song yet.
No,
you haven't heard the song yet?
Come out like Friday.
You. Me of all people, I've not heard the song.
Yeah, but now I have to play the whole thing for you.
You've got to play the whole thing.
Yeah, you have to, legitly.
Oh, is it? Okay. No, because... Gets put out. No, who's it? Gets put out. Saying challenge, saying he's gonna give.
Oh, I was gonna do that anyway.
He's gonna give out £500 to two people who can do his and Kano's verses back to back. In it, this guy was like, "Yo, let's do it."
I can do it by myself.
I'm not gonna be on the gram talking about.
Nah, I'm gonna learn it then.
All right, here we go.
Can we do it?
Let's do it at the live show.
Yeah. Since Act 2 is a goat film, you know.
Yeah. I don't think it will ever get old. No matter how many times I've watched it, I need to go back.
It's a big goat film.
That and Coming to America.
Listen, Coming to America too. I'm gassed.
Yeah, I just hope that they don't water it down at all because Coming to America 1 was like it was proper,
so authentic.
It was just everything about it was just. I don't want them to
barbershop jokes.
Everything.
It's perfect.
I don't want it. I don't want them to like bend to any sort of modern kind of
political. Correct.
Yeah, just do what you're gonna do regardless. Mm. Like, don't worry about the climate at all because.
But then it's like, but then they will have to start discussing other issues.
Like what? What issues were discussed in the first one?
No, but not even
a film for issues.
No,
bro.
But at that time, it
don't
wasn't,
care, bro.
But now you
don't have to address anything.
Yeah.
No, but
like what?
But that's the beauty of certain shows where you address something without addressing it.
Yeah.
No, but we don't have
something
to address
like Insecure. Where things are dealt with in such a smart way. Like, it's not necessary that you have to have a whole debate, but it's just, you know.
Stop bringing your agenda.
I'm not talking about
onto everything.
Because you never know what I'm talking about discussing.
You are.
What?
Anything political.
No.
What then?
This is the world that we live in.
What then?
This is the world that we live in.
What then?
No, I'm saying, no, yeah, that's the world that we live in.
No, but what would you want? What,
no,
what
I would,
secret
no,
message
I would want
do you want it to be underlined in the script?
No, I would want political things to do.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Definitely. We don't want it here, Crystal. Yeah, we want So Glow, barbershop things. Yeah, Arsenio Hall and them man there and all that good stuff, right?
Oh, he signed up to it, isn't it? He's like confirmed he'll be coming back.
Yeah.
And, I bet you there's going to be subtle messages in there.
What is wrong with you, bro?
There will be subtle messages.
Yeah, there might be, but why do you want that?
Because I think that's the beauty of cinema and TV. I don't know, I think that's the beauty of cinema and TV, to deal with certain issues, because I feel like certain people only relate to an issue when they see it on TV. Whatever the issue is.
But they'll start paying attention.
Yeah, well, it doesn't have to even be black people issue. It can be whatever issue.
Listen,
it is.
I just want
to
laugh.
If you're able to depict an issue in a certain way, that's why people love Atlanta. That's why people love Insecure.
Atlanta, even though it's funny.
No, that's not why I love Insecure.
No, Atlanta's
funny, yeah, but what, I swear to you, all they do, is literally read like what's happening on Twitter kind of thing and make an episode about it.
Another the time.
That's,
fuck.
That's what they do, I swear.
Oh, okay. All right, cool. Let's bounce. All right, guys. Live show, don't forget. Tickets are out right now. Meet us after 7. And Friends is going down September the 15th. All right, cool. I've been the always political, the always, you know...
Life is political, baby.
Life is political, baby. Black power to my sisters and all that stuff. Independent woman, single out here, but I got the peas though. What are you saying?
them ones.
Crystal.
Who's next?
I've been the slayer of training.
Yes.
And
he's butchering you right now. I've been the slayer of trading.
I'm shit at these things, man.
Terrible, terrible, terrible.
And yeah, I've been Gina, man. I'm so sorry.
I have been.
I'm so sorry.
I've been. This is basketball. No, man. Big Bad Juice.
Done though.
I've been the. I might make my ex.
Godmother of my child, you know. A certain amount of even mad.
I've been the. I can't
that was all bad. I promise.
Gym without my towel. I've what? Been the. I cream my body. In the weirdest way possible.
Some people here don't even cream their bum, so.
Yeah,
like. My zine still.
Cool.
As glorious as people think Gina's bum is, she doesn't even cream it. Can you imagine this bum you lot are looking at? It's dry underneath the spandex. It's dry. Right, you tell me the truth, Gina. Hey, tell me the truth. So your bum, this bum that everyone's goo-goo gaga over is dry and ashy underneath the leggings.
It's not dry and ashy, cuz.
It might be
the sweat, the sweat's keeping it, moist.
It's cooking.
It's keeping it clammy.
Ew. It's
disgusting.
But make sure you pick out the tissue, yeah? All right, cool.
Dickhead, don't drop the sweat, bitch.
Whoa.
Wait, do you know what's funny?
Yeah, hang on. That's a don't drop the sweat, bitch.
Do it now.
Hang on, intro quickly.
Hi, guys. It's just you here with Big Man News. Dami and Christel, and this is Me Just After 7.
Welcome, guys. Welcome. Episode 143, and we're out.